on, and we are back with another great edition of Flint Flom Bomber Hockey here on Flow TV. The first half of the home-and-home series between the Flint Flom Bombers, LaRon Jaisals, they met twice in the preseason. The Bombers won both those games, but you really can't really count that as LaRon should not have even close to a full lineup. Matter of fact, the first time they played, the Jaisals had 5 16-year-olds in the lineup. Yeah. Well, a lot different look at team tonight. The Bombers going to give Kenny Marquardt his first start of the season. Of course, Laser Hill was in net for back-to-back games on opening weekend. Kenny Marquardt last year, decent numbers, 9-4. He had a couple of shutouts. Wound up with a save percentage of 916 and a goals against of 3.71. So Marquardt gets the call. They're going to go with the... I guess he'll be the reigning number one this year with, of course, the graduation of Dawson Smith. Topher Chirico will get the call tonight. Chirico, of course, the backup and was when called upon last year, did what he needed to do for arguably the best goaltender in the SKHL. Of course, I know Josh Côté, a lot of people would say that he has the right to have that claim from Battleford, but Dawson Smith, very, very good. Chirico will get his third straight start, 1-1 on the year, save percentage of 891. He'll want that to go up. And the goals against a 4.80, which you'll want to get a little bit higher, but a lot of it came in that 8-4 loss to the Melford Mustangs on opening night. We're underway. This is Bukart, part of the big top line for LaRange at center. He's across the Bomber line by himself, throws it on target. Marquardt will make the save and hang on. It'll be interesting because I'm trying to think the last time Marquardt played a game. We mentioned Harbin Laserhoop did the two games to kick off the weekend, and he also played the last preseason game as well, which was a game here against the Ice Wolves as well.
That's right. Yeah, it's good to see Kenny get his first start of the season. You got to play him. He's a good goalie, too, so it's good to see. I'm sure we'll see Laser tomorrow, probably.
So the Bombers will get the puck to the line. It gets kicked out, comes back to center. Flint Flom wearing these nice, bright orange jerseys in honor of Truth and Reconciliation Day, which will be happening across the globe tomorrow. Ice Wolves will be wearing their orange jerseys when they take the ice tomorrow for their home game. This is Forsberg, the very talented Forsberg across the Bomber line, drops this one back. Handle shot. Oh, we had Forsberg open out front. That would have been in if he would have tapped it in late in the drive. They'll fire that over top of the net. Matt Egan after it. He'll slap it down the ice. There's a chance now for Brock Mueller. He'll catch up with it. Mueller, shot from an off angle, goes wide. He'll grab the loose puck himself. Mueller on top of it. Bumped in the corner. He's got Piccinino in there with him. Bombers hold it in. There's a chance on target. That one got kicked out. Right pad save made by Chirico. Here comes Cassette. Two really good lines. Actually, the top two lines for both these teams should be interesting matchups. Of course, Flint Flom got a lot deeper with the addition of Ashton Paul, who they picked up from the Blizzard, and Paul's got the puck right now. Here's a pass to Justin Lees. A couple former Western Hockey Leaguers there. Gary in over the Bomber line. Puck taken away that time by Jacob Wachler up the right side. Blast it down the right side. Here's a chance for Flint Flom right in. Walking behind the net that time was Paul. Didn't shoot it. Good opportunity there for him. He'll throw it back of the goal to Justin Lees. The Northern Manitoba boys going to work. Paul, good work along the boards. Puck comes to blue line. Tater will tap it out. Picked up by Lees at center. Feeds it back to Wachler. Back out front. Quick chance. Fired over top of the net. That time a quick rip by Noah Hull, who got him behind the D. Ice Wolves kind of pinned back in their own zone. Good pressure by the Bombers. They throw it back to blue line. Hull knocked it down. Hull to the slot. Gets a shot away. And that one goes wide again. Bombers keep it in. Blue line again. Wachler's quick shot. That goes wide. Cassette will tap it down the ice. Partial breakaway. Cutting in his handle. Handle it along the backhander. Good save. Kenny Marquardt. And he's tested right off the hop here as the Ice Wolves. That's Cale Taylor, my apologies, that got him behind. I thought it was Handel. They look a lot alike. But anyway, Taylor in behind the D, able to get an opportunity, and there's a nice save to start the game.
What a fantastic save by Kenny. He's going to, that's going to help the confidence. That little first shift of Ashton Paul's, that guy can fly.
Wait till you see him shoot the puck.
He apparently can put it in the net, too.
Yes. Pretty much a point-a-game player in the MJHL. 56 points in 58 games last year. Was out trying to grab a spot in the Western Hockey League. Has wanted to be a Bomber the last couple of years. Got the opportunity. And there's a penalty coming up to Flint Flom right off the hop. 2:32 in the opening period. Penalty going to be handed out to Cohen Sim.
Had a nice chat with Cohen's mom. Hello to Sherry. She's very nice lady. She and Cohen and their family very excited that he's a Flin Flon Bomber.
So the Ice Wolves 2-for-13 so far in the season. We talk about Flin Flon's power play woes. The good news is they haven't given up a power play goal either. The Bombers have been able to kill off all eight power plays against them. So a very good penalty kill so far. Here's Cassette. It'll need to be good again. The Ice Wolves will go to work. Tucking behind the Bomber net, picked up by Vaakler, but taken away in the corner that time by Bukart. Bukart along the boards has got handle with him. Puck is knocked free. That's grabbed here by the Bombers. Silvestri set the length of the ice, and Leighton thought about coming back, but the goalie played up ahead to Bukart. Bukart with Forsberg. They jam up. The puck just gets lifted out. Leighton will grab it outside the Bomber blue line. Whistles this back in Flin Flon territory. Kenny Marcourt stopped that back of the net. It's fired around the boards, but, oh, another penalty coming up here. This time it might be going to LaRange. One of the Bombers, it looks like it's Noah Hull was knocked down back of the net. Interference penalty coming up, so this will negate the Ice Wolf power play. An interference call being called here. This is going to be handed out here to William Forsberg.
And we see Fabrice Bourgeois in the lineup for the first time. He didn't take kindly to the liberties taken to Noah Hull. Fabrice, a big young man. He's just looking here. He's 6'2", 204 pounds from St. Augustine, Quebec.
They're having trouble with the power play times up here. They got 2 minutes up on the Ice Wolf side here. I'm saying roughly they must have been 40 or 45 seconds gone. But they're having some difficulties with that. But we are going to be 4-on-4 here. I'm thinking for roughly a minute. Ice Wolf's quick in the center. This is Taylor across the line. Drop that one back. A shot by Hodge. That redirects off the stick and goes out of play. So a minute 49.
Yeah, they have it backwards up there.
Well, I don't even see the other penalty time,
no,
do you?
No, it's not. They have the they're getting it straightened here, I think.
There we go.
They got it backwards, but
anyway, we're going to be 4-on-4 for another minute four. Then the Bombers will get roughly a 44-second power play. Matt Egan deep inside his own zone, lifts it back of the goal. That's Tanchuk. They get it back to Egan at center, knocked down, but picked up here quickly by the speedy Bourgeois. He gets it back out front. Liam Butcher cutting the front of the net. Bourgeois back to blue line, knocked down by Tanchuk. Here's Egan. Quick chance, a good right arm stopped that time by Chirico. A lot of room there for Matt Egan, who did get a goal in his opening game this year. I'm sure felt a major load off his shoulders getting that goal right off the hop. Wolves back to center. Taylor again dropped it back to Silzer. Top of the right circle, shot right on. Stopped here by Marquardt. Rebound, no. The Wolves pick it up right back up front to Bukart. His quick chance off the goal post. Back close to being 1-0. Flin Flon having a tough time getting it out. Here's Franz cutting in from the right side. He'll flip that over top of the net. Held it at the left point that time by Silzer. Throws it out front. Grabbed here by Bourgeois. Ahead to Egan at center. Flin Flon with the power play here in a couple of seconds. LaRange is now 0-for-1 tonight, but they have the puck in their own zone. Silzer up to Bukart. They'll get enough of it to tap it in. Picked up here by Noah Hull. Back of the Bomber net. 36 seconds left of power play time. Scoreless just underway in the opening period. Here's the quick give to Silvestri. Back to Lees. Lees quickly across the line. Back to Silvestri. He fanned on it. Walker will pick it up. Silvestri back of the goal, back out front to Lees. Still looking for his first regular season SJHL goal. Had a hat-trick against the Mustangs in the preseason. Walker walks in, a quick chance. That got blocked out front. Walker gets his own rebound. Around the boards, Lees is there. He'll knock it down and hold it in. Justin Lees along the boards. Lees trying to dance away from traffic, banks it off the boards. Noah Hull, quick chance, kicked out that time. Chirico rebound. Turn to the blue line, held in by Walker. Penalty is over. And Flin Flon 0-for-1 to start the game. Puck back of the Ice Wolf net. They'll get it back out front to Hull. Shoveled it back of the goal. This is Silvestri. Scores! Alexi Silvestri! What a goal! Only goal to goalie. And that's Alexi Silvestri's first of the season. And what a beauty might slip out of the corner behind the net.
It sure was. It was from a funny angle, but Alexi took that shot, was able to beat Chirico. Great play. Boy, Justin Lees had a good power play there.
He sure did.
He can handle that puck. He's not showing any effects from what I believe was a Charlie horse last week.
Yeah, he is a little bit banged up entering the regular season. So Alexei Silvestri gets his first of the year. This might be an unassisted goal. We'll have to wait and see.
The assist to number 41,
nope.
Jacob Bachler.
Bachler will get an assist on it.
5:33.
So that's Bachler's first point of the year. We're talking about that top line needing to get going, and a good start for them. The Bombers up to a 1-0 lead. They got the puck again. They'll get it to center. This is Iwanis across the LaRange line. Franz stopped him. They're offside. Well over to the right. Brock Mueller says that the guy had him hooked up, but he was still 10 feet over the line before they blew it down. .13:55 to go in the opening period. Lynn Vaughn a quick 1-0 lead and a goal by Alexei Silvestri, who of course had a great year last year. 21 goals he scored as a rookie. Gets his first one here this year. Layton spins and banks it off the boards. It's going to chase the Bombers back in their own zone. It will be an icing call as Chichu Lapton will touch up back of the Flint Fawn net. Busy night in the SPHL tonight there, Mike Slip, as we got a lot of action. The big game tonight, or a couple big games here tonight. You got the Weyburn Red Wings taking on the Estevan Bruins. Kindersley and Nipawin tonight. What else do we got? Battleford at Yorkton. Stars rolling back for the Western League. They're going to need him after losing 8-4 in Yorkton yesterday. Notre Dame, who Flint Fawn will see next weekend. They're in Melford tonight, so we'll keep up to date on all those games with our out-of-town scoreboard. 1-0 here. Flint Fawn just hitting a goal post here just moments ago. Almost made it 2-0. Puck is scooped up here by Layton. He'll get it to center. That's picked up by Hodge, who dumps it back into Flint Fawn zone, so goal post both ways here early. Here's Joey Lees for Flint Fawn. Quick pass. Bridger tried to grab it at center. He does. Liam Bridger across the line. A quick shot. That redirected off Sulzer. It just went wide. So Flint Fawn really skating here so far. Here comes Dragon the other way. He gets it tight. Look out. Open net. Flipped over top of the Bomber net. And we got a major confrontation here at the crease. Trying to make out the numbers here. That's Cohen sent for Flint Fawn. Kenny Marcourt down. Dragon made a good play, got in, got the toe drag, got a good chance. Marcourt stopped that, but the rebound was flipped over top of the net, and I'm assuming more penalties are going to be handed out here.
Yeah, that was quite the mayhem there. Yeah, here both of them going to go, probably the right call. Kenny Marcourt was on the bottom of that pile.
Baldwin will go for LaRange. Semp will go for Flint Fawn, so I'm thinking coincidental roughings. Yeah, roughing is the call for both those guys. So more four-on-four hockey, which I enjoy.
It opens the ice. You're right, though, Rob. The Bombers are looking a lot quicker and a little more pep in their step tonight than they did last week against the Melford Mustangs.
Cassette against Pinocchio. Face-off in the Flint Fawn zone. The left of the goaltender, Kenny Marcourt. 1-0 Flint Fawn. Here's Pinocchio at center. He'll take off quickly across the LaRange line. Pinocchio will bring it in. His backhander stopped here by Chirico. The one thing that Flint Fawn's doing well, they're getting the puck in deep, and they're getting shots on net.
Yeah, they're driving to the net. I learned how to say his name, Piccinino.
Piccinino.
Peach,
okay.
Kenny Marquardt told me that they've now named him Peach. So I think I have that right. I sure hope so. Piccinino. He's been a great addition so far.
Lees wins the faceoff. Flint Fawn will try to work it in. This one will come outside the zone. Grabbed here by the Bombers' Bourgeois. Here's a quick pass picked up by Piccinino. He can't knock it down. Puck lifted back towards the Bomber blue line. This is Noah Hull. Taylor on top of him. Hull redirects back of his own net around the boards here. Big body check there. Cassette steps into his guy. Gets the puck free. Looking to get a shot away, but knocked away. Nice job here by Lees to get it back the other direction. Graham will cut that one off. Intercepted by Piccinino. He's got to wait for Hull to get back outside. He'll drop it back to center where it's picked up this time by Bourgeois. Bourgeois inside the Flint Fawn zone. Passes that up the middle. Picked up here by Piccinino. Dropped it off to Lees. Quick chance. That one got blocked again. Bourgeois will pick up the loose puck. Drops it to the blue line. Nobody there. Break away. Here comes Bucart. In a long Bucart. Backhander. Oh, Kenny Marcourt is there. Terrific save again. And now they've given up the ice here to Silvestri. It's a 2-on-1. Silvestri, please shoot. Fires on the top of the net. What a setup by Alexei Silvestri. They're going end-to-end here at the Whitney Farm in the opening period. Penalty could be handed out here. Maybe not. Meanwhile, Flint Fawn back on the rush. Ashton Paul down the way. Paul shoots. See, rebound is behind. Jericho back up front. And that's fired wide that time by the Bomber defenseman, Yakimchuk. Boy, Ashton Paul been on the ice twice tonight, Mike Slip, and it's been pretty darn exciting.
Really exciting. Yeah. He's look, looking fantastic so far. Net came off there. I know a few of the boys were upset about it because they had a wide open one, but Ashton Falls.
What an entertaining opening period of hockey. 11:34 to go. 1-0 Flin Flon. They win the faceoff. This is Chalashats. That didn't miss by much. Buck rolling in front of Chirico. He's going to jump on that. The shots, by the way, are 7-5 in favor of Flin Flon. One concern for Colt McKay tonight, though. The Bombers have given up a couple of breakaways here early.
Yeah, they have. But it's because they're pressing, Rob, like we said, they're going in on that net, and, you know, that'll turn it around sometimes the other way. But Kenny Marquardt coming up big.
Kenny Marquardt looking good in his debut so far. This is the big defenseman, Layton. Drops it back to center, picked up by Foster. He's across the Bomber line. Down the wing, a quick chance. That sails on top of the net. Loose puck grabbed by Silvestri. Can't get it out. Puck stays in. This is Bukart, who had that breakaway earlier. Puck cut free. Here's Silvestri, the goal scorer. He's got Paul with him. Paul takes the pass. Paul down the wing, a chance, and he just ripped it wide again. Boy, Ashton Paul getting a lot of chances. Another steal. Partial breakaway. Bukart again. Bukart down the right side. Rips out up the right shoulder of Kenny Marquardt. Boy, these teams are almost going River Pond hockey here. Here's Aiden Chow back the other way, quickly across the line. He gets a quick chance. Rebound is laying there, and Buckler can't tap it in. Wolves clear it. Cassette comes back, gets the pass at his blue line. Cassette to center. Back across the Bomber line, waits to set it up, fires it out front. That's Franz. He'll bring it back in deep. Franz hangs on to it along the wall. They send it back out front, knocked down by Handel. A quick chance. Forecourt to save. Puck is loose in front. Down again. They can't jam it in. And another penalty coming up as Cassette gets hammered behind the net. And boy, these teams really going at each other. And I'll tell you what, you talk about Flin Flon getting lots of chances. They have not played very good defensively at all. Two or three goal line scrambles in front of Marquardt. They got to help the goalie out
here. Yeah, they sure do. Kenny's beat. He's a fantastic
under siege here a couple of times.
Aiden Chow had a good shift there, although it was more offensive. He had two shots, but he had a real nice back check on almost a breakaway.
So the Wolves come close again, 10:20 to go, already at the midway point of the period. That's how exciting it's been here tonight. A big shout out to a good buddy of mine, Jamie Smalley. He and his wife listening to the game in San Jose, California tonight.
Nice.
You gotta love modern technology. You're never too far away from this great Flin Flon Bomber action. Bridger out front to Bachler, got away from him. Silzer is in there, big defenseman. Flipped into the far corner. Cassette. Drop that one back. Here's a quick pass to Handel. He's got it at center. Up the middle. Cut again. Opportunity for Forsberg. And that one knocked away. And that's another partial breakaway. They're really getting in behind the Flin Flon Bomber.
You're right. Cole McKay has to figure this out and get the defensive, the back end of the Bombers. Ain't that what that three? Almost four. Aiden Chow was able to break one off. But that's way too many. It's going to come back and bite them.
Media timeout here, Mike. Let's see what's happening. Get your little phone out there. Let's check what's happening at the world of sports. A couple of football games. Of course, we got a lot of baseball games going on here tonight. Mike Slip, a diehard Blue Jay fan.
No.
He'll be having his crying towel out here by this time next week when they're out. The Argos up on the Blue Bombers, even without Chad Kelly, the one at 14-7 early in the second quarter there, Mike.
Argos are
the best team in the league.
They are.
Wouldn't that be something if they beat Winnipeg without Chad Kelly and apparently a lot of other regulars?
Yeah.
They see Saskatchewan later tonight. That's a big game as well. Go ahead.
We were talking about the Argos earlier. They put a nice team together. And Chad Kelly's just had a heck of a season.
Does he win the league MVP?
So far.
You think so?
Yep.
I like that quarterback at Edmonton. To me, he's the most exciting player in the league.
He turned that team around, really.
Yeah, they might just actually make the playoffs. Could you imagine if they would have had him when they opened things up?
Yeah.
They probably would have won those two games against Saskatchewan earlier this year. Anyway, back to the action here at the Whitney Forum. A 1-0 Flin Flon lead. The Wolves have been pressing, though, taking advantage of some not great defensive play by the Bombers. But you got to give LaRange credit. They got some pretty good offensive players in their own right. Here's a pass up the middle. They tried to get that one over to Mueller. That's broken up. That's set back inside the Flin Flon zone. Poole there quickly to grab the puck at the side of his own net. Off the board. Try to come back to Mueller too far. Cut off by Graham on the Ice Wolves side of center. Drop that one back to Gary. Mueller took it from him. Oh, Mueller hit from behind. It's going to be a penalty. Both referees got their hands up.
Yeah.
And we'll see if they can finally get things going on the power play. D The addition of Ashton Paul, I cannot say enough how much he's going to help their power play out.
Yeah, absolutely, and they need to help. Last game, I don't know how many power plays they had.
Well, they're 0 for 12 and 0 for 13 now on the air.
Yeah.
By the way, Blue Jays up big time, 8-2 in the sixth inning tonight.
Wow.
So let's see what the Bombers can do on the power play. Still looking for that elusive first power play goal of the year. They got a lot of artillery out there. Ashton Paul will come out up front with Sylvester, who's got the goal. Justin Lees, Noah Hull, and Jacob Wachler. Geez, I mean, that's a lot of heavy artillery here, is it not?
That's a heck of a line.
Buck comes the blue line, just held in by Hull. This is Lees, who looked good on the first power play tonight. Lees has got it. Back to Hull. Through traffic, shot that one, didn't miss by much. Wachler will knock it down. Wachler's got it, banks it back to blue line. Hull sends it across to Lees, back out front. Wachler can't shoot. He'll keep it in. Top of the circle for Lees, throws it back out front. Hull in the corner for Paul. Ashton Paul dropped it back out front. Still no shot. Hull will hang on. Good box out here by the Ice Wolves. Silvestri to Hull. Falls down. Puck squirts free and set back to center ice. Looking for it that time was Tokic. Lees will get it back. He'll take off. Lees down the right side inside the Ice Wolves zone. Around the boards it goes to Wachler. Wachler will knock it down. He just keeps it in. Oh, it comes across the blue stripe. A minute two to go in the power play. Maybe trying to get too fancy here. Handel knocks that one away. Sends it back across the Flin Flon line. Wachler back to center. Will stick handle it in. Give the Wolves credit. I'm not giving Flin Flon anything again here on this power play. Silvestri in the corner. Knocked it down. Left point. Lees calls for it. Lees has got a quick chance. Big save. Jericho rebound out front. And Silvestri couldn't sneak that one through. Tanchuk tapped it in deep. This is Wachler. Back out front to Silvestri. Puck is bouncing. Picked up here by Forsberg. And 30 seconds remaining in the power play. Cole Tanchuk to touch up back of the Bomber net. 25 seconds to go in the power play. 7:41 here in the opening frame. Here comes Liam Bridger. Down the side. Ripped that one over top of that. Bridger sets a good chance tonight, but he's also had a hard time hitting the net. He's looked good, though. He's skating very hard. Leighton back of the goal. Gets that one past Egan. And that'll force Tanchuk back inside his own zone. 5 seconds to go in the power play as he gets away from Birch. And that'll do it. Flin Flon's power play troubles continue. Here's the pass to Bridger. Didn't see it, a little bit behind him. He's tied up. Rebound or loose puck picked up by Babich, and he'll send it down the ice. Easy save for Marquardt. Shots, by the way, dead even now at 11 apiece here in this opening period. Flin Flon in their own zone. Here's the quick pass to Joey Lees. Joey Lees to center. Baldwin bumps with him. Puck lifted inside the Wolves zone. Grabbed by Sulzer back of his own net. Up to Cassette. Back Catter will make it back to center. Chow cut that one off. Trying to come back to Pinchadino. He couldn't knock it down. The Bombers dump it in for Mueller. Mueller back of the goal for Lees. Lees got that big goal a week ago tonight in Nippon. Nice way for him to kick off his season. Here's Leighton. Off the boards. Knocked down here by Iwanis. Tried to come back out front. Intercepted. Lees will hold it in. To the point. Chow. Wrong shot. Deflected. Just went wide that time. Good opportunity here by Mueller. Jericho will grab it at the side of the goal. 6:23 to go, opening period, Mike, and the power play trying to get too fancy.
Yeah. Boy, Aiden Chow has had some good opportunities here today. He's got a good shot. I don't know if he's going to get you many goals, but he's going to get that puck on net, and those forwards have to be there and throw in the junk, but I sure like watching Joey Lees play, or Justin, both Joey and Justin, but Justin tonight is just so smooth with that puck. He's... And then you had Ashton Paul.
Forsberg lining up for the faceoff here against the Bombers, Stenglund. Stenglund, the SJHL Rookie of the Week. 3 goals, 4 points in the first couple of games. It's a chance to play. So some pretty good players. And Jacob Wachler and Alexi Silvestri. Speaking of Wachler, he's got the puck inside his own zone. He'll take off. Wachler got an assist on the opening goal. Gets it back to Silvestri. Back up front to Wachler. Quick shot! Score! What a beautiful goal! Jericho still looking for it. Well, Silvestri and Wachler, lots of opportunities in the first couple of games, Mike. They've got their mojo going early tonight.
night.
They sure do. How about those hands on both those guys?
How about a heck of a shot, Jericho? Look at, he's still wondering where, how that shot got in.
And then I was just going to say, and then the shot from Locklear. What a great goal that was. This is a great hockey game. You're right, Rob, so far.
Bombers might be a little bit fortunate to be up after giving up quite a few chances, but they'll take a 2-0 lead. And Jacob Locklear gets his first of the year. Cassette's going to touch this offside. I don't know if he realized that it was. Anyway, Flint fought a quick 2-0 lead. And Aiden Chow will pick up the second assist on that one. But holy cow, if you can get Silvestri and Locklear looking like they do tonight, they could score. They have the potential to be a very lethal unit this year.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, we were wondering about the missing Dupereau and Mercier and those fellas, but some guys that are stepping
well,
in.
Well, again, not to sound like a broken record, but the addition of Ashton Paul is huge.
Yeah, absolutely.
Puck is lifted back down the ice. I was very, very excited when I found out that he was coming to Flint Flon. Very, very gifted offensive player who's got the puck right now. Paul, the center, will dump the puck back inside the Wolves zone. There comes the ice float netminder out to play it. He'll throw it to the corner. Paul's got it again. Paul also a big body, as you can see.
Yeah.
Good work in the corner. He does get tripped up here. Wolves do get it outside the zone. It gets redirected to the Bomber blue line. Picked up here by Bourgeois. Feeds it back to Houle. Back up the middle. Here's Piccinino. Piccinino across the line. Feeds it into Paul. Paul thought about shooting, and he'll hang on to it. Ashton Paul makes his way to the blue line. Back up front. Nice pass. Bourgeois scores! Off a skate and in. His first NHL goal. Bourgeois able to get that in. I believe it went off the ice float defenseman skate. Ashton Paul should get the assist, or one of them anyway.
Yeah, absolutely. They've gone high. All three goals have been up high.
No, that one hit a skate and went in low.
Did it?
Yeah.
I thought it went over his shoulder.
Off a skate and went low.
Oh, I thought it went over his shoulder.
No, goalie had no chance on it.
Yeah. So, but great shots. Yeah, all of them. All.
That'll come at the 15:05 mark, so almost identically a minute after Vaucler made it a 2-0 game. So three goals for the Bombers tonight. Three players that all have their first goal of the season. So Bourgeois will get his first ever SJHL goal. And he'll take it on a beautiful feed here from Ashton Paul. And the Flint Flon Bombers jump up by a score of 3-0 here with just under 5 minutes to play in the opening period. Liam Bridger at center ice. Kicked that one ahead. Puck will roll to Chirico. He's got it. And Piccinino will get a second assist on that one. And boy, Flint Flon really flying here tonight with 4.5 minutes remaining in the opening period. They're only out shooting the Ice Wolves 13-12, but been able to score a couple really nice goals. And again, that third one, no chance for the Mirage Netminder when it goes off a skate. Faceoff back inside the Wolves zone as they dig in. Kemp wins the draw, gets it back to Laughlin. Laughlin takes him off, gets a quick chance, and there's off the chest pad grabbed here by Chirico. And boy, Flint Flon, if they could maybe get one more late goal here, it'd be kind of interesting. Because like you and I have said this before, you can never count out a Kevin Kaminsky team and look for them to really come back strong. Especially if they can get a goal here late to answer that, look for them to come out very strong in the second. A
lot of hockey left.
Once again, the faceoff inside the Wolves zone. Puck held in here by Laughlin. Got it in deep. That's Semph in the corner. Trying to come back out front. Tied up here by Baldwin. Sulzer in there as well. There's a big hit. Ooh. Penalty coming up here to Liam Bridger. And Foster going to mix it up here with Sem. We'll see how they rule this one. Is it a charge? I believe that's probably what they'll call. Because I don't think he hit him from the side. He didn't really hit him from behind. But Bridger is going off. Warning penalty. So the Wolves an opportunity here. Big power play for them. Try to answer some of the Bomber offense here early.
This score could easily be tied if it wasn't for Kenny Marquardt.
Well, two breakaway saves and a couple of goal line scrambles.
Yeah.
There's a goal post by LaRange as well in the opening period.
Yes.
So we'll see what happens here. The Ice Wolves back on the power play, like you said, entering the game here tonight. We're 2-for-13. They're 0-for-1 tonight. But remember, that first chance was only 44 seconds. Forsberg lines up against Silvestri. The Wolves win the draw. Here's Cassette inside the blue line. Cassette, the former Beardies Blackhawk. Back to Layton. He fanned on that one. Knocked down by Locklear. There's a chance for Silvestri. Short-handed trying to come in on Layton. Layton just got a piece of it. tapped into the corner. Silvestri tries to tie that one up. Forsberg comes over, takes it from him, and he'll drop it back of the goal here for Leighton. A minute 35 to go in the power play. 3:42 remaining in the opening period. A 3-0 Flin Flon lead. This is Forsberg. Back to Leighton, overskated it a little bit. Had to be careful. Gives it away anyway. Stolen this time by the Bombers, Townchuk, who gets a quick chance. And good glove save made by Chirico. Wolves have to regroup back in their own net. This is Leighton. Inside his own zone. The cassette at center. Gets at the handle. Handle across the Bomber line. Drop that back to Leighton. A chance. And Marquardt will reach up and he'll nab that in midair with a minute 2 to go in the power play. 3:11 remaining in the opening period. And I think one of the reasons why you're seeing such a quick-paced period tonight, the Melford Mustangs, the last team that was here, go in and it was a snooze fest, but that's how Trevor Blevins plays.
Yeah.
Everything's locked up. Everything's kept to the outside. Both these teams want to skate tonight.
They sure do. Yeah, you're absolutely right.
So we're seeing a lot better pace than we saw in that last game. But again, to Trevor Blevins' credit, I mean, why would you want to skate with a team if you don't have the horses to go head-to-head? You got to play the style that gets you there. And when you're on the road, Ice Wolves a chance to knock this one in. The puck is off the crease. They knock it in. No! Referee going to wave it off. The Wolves come close and hit the crossbar. It was down behind Kenny Marquardt. They did jam it in. But the referee is saying no goal, and I'm wondering why.
Well, I'll tell you, I think that first shot was in. I could be wrong, and there's no replay like you say, Rob. But
you
I think
the first one was in?
I think it went under the crossbar, but
okay.
Again, I could be wrong. It did. He hit part of the crossbar.
Well, I can hear it up here.
Yeah.
I want to know why that didn't count. Did the whistle go too quickly?
Raf must have lost sight.
Interesting, though. Was your initial shot in? Would love to see a replay on that. Wolves continue to work around the power play. Hodge to the blue line. Sends that across the ice. Picked up here by Franz. Side of the goal. They come right back out front. Knocked down again by Hodge. Hodge has got it. He'll drop it back in the corner. Wolves work it back up front. This is Taylor. Back of the goal for Hodge. Hodge trying to jam it in. There's Taylor after it again. Back out. He's taken down. Gets back up, pinned up along the boards. Knocked free. Grabbed here by Hodge. Spins, fire, save made. Loose puck. Can they jam this one in? Oh, my goodness. Aiden Chow going to get a penalty. His night could be done. As he absolutely drilled somebody into the boards. It's Taylor, and Taylor is in all kinds of discomfort. But no question about this one, Mike slipped. I think Aiden Chow's game is done.
Might be.
It sure. He hit him from behind clearly.
Yeah. Oh, he's hurt.
The guy was going down, but he's actually, I think he's got the wind knocked out of him, but it's probably fortunate for him he was going down. Otherwise, he would have really planted him in there.
Got two Ice Wolves that are injured.
Yeah, Dragon
five
looks
minutes,
like he might be
he got 5 minutes, I think. It says two up there.
He's done, too.
Yeah, that's the second game in a row, Aiden Chow.
Well, there was no doubt about that one.
I agree, and no doubt, really, about the last one.
So Aiden Chow's night is over. It's a hit from behind. It'll be a 5-minute major penalty. And that's how quickly momentum can change in a hockey game. Flin Flon looking like they had things going their way. The 3-0 lead, boy. And the ISO power plays look really good here. They hit a crossbar, came close to scoring again.
And they you know what caused these penalties is scrambly. They've gotten scrambly here at the end of this period. And yeah, I believe Hayden, this is a 5-minute penalty,
yeah.
Like I say, Rob.
Well,
yeah.
He took him down pretty badly.
Yeah. There's a couple of Ice Wolves hurt after that play.
Now, did that initial penalty, is it over? Were they back to full? They were back to full strength, right?
It looks like there's four players out there for the Bombers, so yeah.
Okay, so this will be a 5-minute major penalty, which will obviously carry over to the second period with just 2:03 remaining here in the opening period. Aiden Chow hit from behind. His game is over. Now the Ice Wolves a really good opportunity to get back in the hockey game. This is Rockler. Down the ice on target. And Chirico will make the save and Leighton will take over. Less than 2 minutes to go. And the Bombers down to D-man. Cassette comes back to take the pass. Gets it to Forsberg. Forsberg put there across the line. Up the wall. Forsberg and a few other Ice Wolves converge on it, but a tap back down the ice. Chirico will stop this and Leighton will come over and pick it up back of his own net. Shots are dead even at 15 apiece, but a 3-0 Flin Flon lead. Here's the pass to Cassette. Down the wing. Gets away, throws it back out front. Intercepted by Hulme, couldn't get much wood on it. Wolves will keep it right back in. Nice job that time by Bukart. Wolves throw it back out front. Intercepted Montler. Back down the ice it goes. Jericho up the plate. Forsberg onside. Got it. Oh, maybe not. I think they're going to say that Handel over on the left wing, a little extra anxious, so that's why they'll blow that down. But 106 remaining in the period, 4:03. The good news is for the Bombers, if they can kill this minute six, they'll get a bit of a breather coming up for the remainder of that five-minute major.
Yeah. Jericho, Laser Hume plays that puck nicely. He's made some good passes, although that went offside.
Yeah, he gets on it pretty quickly. Maybe. Wolves win the draw inside their own zone. They're trying to get cut into this lead here late in the period. Hodge will dump it in. He had those chances the last time he was out there. Puck deep inside the Bomber zone as they try to pin it up along the boards. Wolves looking to dig it free. They do. Hodge back of the Bomber net. Dropped it back there for Taylor. Taylor back out front to Hodge. Taylor's been one of the better forwards for the Wolves tonight. Hodge through traffic. Shoots that one. Save made. Rebound. Marquardt's got that. Puck is picked up by Tanchek. Ripped around the boards, but Silver will keep it in. Silver at the blue line. Top of the right circle for Hodge. Lots of traffic in front of that Flin Flon Bomber net. Hodge has it. Looking for a lane. Made a good move. Hodge still has control. Backhander side of the goal for Taylor. Can he jam it in? He throws it up front. Silver! Oh, he drilled that one. He just fired it wide. Puck picked up and set back down the ice here by Iwanis. 15 seconds to go in the period. Picked up quickly here by Silver, who's going to have to hurry. Back to center ice. Here's Gary. Across the Bomber line. Back to Taylor. Through traffic. Throws that towards the front of the net. They're going to ahead of Kenny Marquardt again. They shoot from the corner. They score. With 0.7 of a second up there on the corner, Bukart will get the power play goal. And that's got to be a lift for LaRange coming out for the second period. 0.7 of a second.
I'd like to see that three-point. Kenny Marquardt wasn't happy with the call. I don't know why. It looked like a good shot to me. Here we go.
To me, too. Bukart will get it on the power play. That is his first of the year. And that'll come at the 19:59 mark.
Ice Wolves have been swarming. Of course, they got the five-minute power play, but
like you said, this very well could be a tie. LaRange might even be able to have the lead at this point.
Yeah.
But they get a big goal here with less than a full second to go. Bukart on the power play. As we get the announcement on the goal. How about the play of Taylor, who got the assist? I think he's been their best forward here in the first period.
Absolutely, and you know, the Bombers have some great forwards out there themselves. And Silvestri, our new man Ashton Paul, Justin Lees, Bourgeois, although a defenseman. Really exciting first period of hockey, Rob.
Again, though, Flin Flon's going to have to get a lot better defensively.
Killer not happy with the referees.
Well, I don't know why he's complaining about the ref ring. I haven't seen anything
that they missed.
Yeah, I mean, it was definitely hit from behind. They called on Chow. There was no doubt about that one. And I thought they caught the other penalty on Bridger when he charged at the guy. So
yeah.
Anyway, it's a 3-1 Flin Flon lead. But good news for the Ice Wolves, they still have 3 minutes of power play time when they come out for the second. Look for them to really come out strong, Mike. The Flin Flon's going to have to be ready to go, and they're going to have to make some adjustments defensively. They can't play the whole game like this.
No, I'll tell you, if it wasn't for Kenny Marquardt, it would be a complete different story. The Bombers offensively have looked great, but defensively not so much.
All righty, we will take a look at the scoring summary before we wrap things up here in the opening period. Alexei Silvestri, a beautiful goal. Jacob Bachler, it just came after a power play. The Bombers had the puck in behind the LaRange net. Silvestri just a nice picture-perfect shot, and I don't think Jericho was set for it. I don't think he even knew where Silvestri was on the ice.
I think you're right there, Rob. A couple of those, I think he just couldn't see the puck.
So 1-0 Flin Flon. Jacob Bachler on the quick rush. Silvestri feeds him. He goes flying in down the left wing and got Jericho deep in his net. Beat him low glove side. A picture-perfect shot. His first of the year at 14:03. Then they get a real break. Bourgeois' first ever SJHL goal. Off the boards. Fires it out front. Off the ice. Full defenseman skating in. Ashton Paul, the newcomer. And Picciotto get the second assist on that one. But with less than a full second to go, we talked about could the Ice Wolves get that late goal to rally them. They got it. Bucourt out of the corner, proving again, kids, if you're watching this game, listening to this game somewhere, that's why when your coach always tells you to shoot the puck, you do it. A shot on net can always be a good thing. Wasn't really a terrifically good shot. Well placed, mind you.
Yeah.
But he put it on net, and look out, it went in. His first of the year. Tanner the assist. That's a big goal for Laurent. Right back in the game now, 3-1 after one.
Yeah, as they say, exciting. And that was an awkward angle like the Silvestri goal. But as you say, Rob, put it on the net. If they're not on the net, they don't go in.
Shots in the opening period favor the Ice Wolves, 17-16. And again, the Flint Flon Bomber power play struggling. They are 0-2 in this game. Laurent is 1-3. And like I said, we'll get 3 minutes of that major penalty assist to Aiden Chow to start the second. So good opportunity for them. We'll take a break. We'll come back with the second period on Flow TV. But so far, the Flint Flon Bombers leading actually all four goals tonight. All players getting their first of the season. Silvestri, Bachler, and Bourgeois for Flint Flon. Burkhart's replied for the Wolves of the power play. We'll take a break. The second period coming up momentarily. teams have made their way back out on the ice. And again, a 3-1 Flintstorm lead after 20 minutes of play. And a very big goal for LaRon Dysols to score with less than a full second on. And, you know, as Kevin Kaminsky left the ice, he obviously didn't look too happy. He didn't look too happy with a 3-0 deficit. But you know what? If this game continues to the trend that it's on right now, if I'm Kevin Kaminsky, I think I like that.
Yeah, no, you don't want to change anything, I don't think. You just, you know, the Bombers got some nice shots on net that the goalie would have a hard time stopping. The Icicles would look great. I would expect that Coach Cole McCaig was preaching defense.
Well, he should be. Because I'll tell you, that probably as weak defensively as I've seen this team play in a number of years. They give up way too many quality opportunities. Icicles will begin the period on the power play. It's that 5-minute major. They got the puck quickly across the Bomber line. There's an opportunity. Cassetta shot right on. Marquardt was looking behind him. He did stop it. And the Bombers get a hold of it. Nice job this time by Chichi Lapka to shovel it down the ice. Jericho will make the save, and Leighton will pick it up back of his net. So 2.5 remaining in the major penalty. Just underway in the second period. Again, Flintstorm in front 3-1. Forsberg at center. He'll dump it in deep. Bachler's got a goal and an assist tonight. Gets the puck to blue line. Held in by Leighton. Good work along the boards this time by Bukart, who's got the ice full goal. Stood up here by Bachler. Got it back of the net. That was Handel with Forsberg. Dropped it back of the goal for Handel. Back out front. Forsberg doesn't grab it, but Cassette does. Cassette along the left-hand side of the board, looking for a lane to shoot it. Dropped the side of the goal. Handel with some room. He'll hang on. Back out front. Cassette poked away. Great defensive play that time by Silvestri. Maybe the Wolves trying to get too cute there, like Flintstorm was doing earlier. Wolves will send it back in. 1:45 to go on the power play. Jacob Bachler will take off at his own blue line. Great move there. Rockler shorthanded. Todrad! Puck behind him. He's not sure where it is. Taylor will grab it the other way. And he'll take up off the ice. Taylor, a good move. Still has it. Taylor! Back to Silzer. Just holds it in. Feeds it back out front to Taylor. Had a terrific opening period. In the corner. The Wolves try to set things up again. They'll go back to Silzer. His shot. Knocked away. Blocker save made that time by Marquardt. Loose puck picked up by the Wolves Dragon. He's pinned up along the boards this time by Noah Hull. Meanwhile, the seconds tick down. 1:08 remaining in the major penalty. Big scrum deep in the Flintstorm zone. Finally, puck comes free. Franz has got it for the Wolves. Franz along the boards. Left it there for Hodge. Hodge trying to keep it in. Comes free. Hull trying to get away. And he gets stuck into the ice. He might have oversold that a little bit, but it worked. And it's going to be 4-on-4 for 49 seconds. Nonetheless, great, great effort by Noah Hull.
Yeah, he keeps those feet moving, and things happen. You might be right.
He did, and Hodge is laughing about it. But anyway, good job by Noah Hull to knock it down. It'll be 4-on-4, and the Bombers will get a brief power play as well. Still looking for that elusive first power play goal of the season.
That's important there, that penalty that gets into even strength with 49 seconds left in the major.
Based off of the Wolf zone, Bombers win the draw. Picked up back of the net that time by Piccinino. Piccinino's got it. Back of the net, swatted away that time by Chirico. Piccinino will go back to grab it in the corner. Piccinino deep in LaRange territory, looking for someone to give it to. Good work along the boards. Piccinino still has it. Made a good move there. Out front. Oh, great save there, Chirico. He'll rob Colin Semp, but tremendous work there. Piccinino, the stick on a string. He was doing a little zipsy doodling all over the place. Couldn't take the puck away from Fenn out front perfectly to Semp. And that's probably the save of the game for Chirico.
It was a beauty. Boy, the goaltending in this league is good for the last number of years.
A fantastic save there. Keeps it 3-1. Flintstorm 4-on-4 for another 27 seconds. And the official over at the LaRange bench here. And now they'll drop the puck to the right of Chirico. Piccinino stays out there, wins the faceoff. Back of the net, tried to tap that one in. Chirico got his goal stick on it. Looked like he was going to be able to bank it in from back there. Piccinino tried to grab a hold of it. Got a piece that couldn't knock it down. Handley. Here comes Handel for the Wolves. Handel to center. Flip that back across the Flintstorm Bomber blue line. Tanchuk is in there. Handel took it from him, gets it back to Graham at the left point. His long shot didn't miss by much. Flintstorm set to go on the power play. They'll poke it ahead. Piccinino feeds it back to Semp from the penalty box. The is Stenglund, who is serving the five-minute major penalty. Stenglund had a heck of an opening weekend, dropped it back to Vogler. His shot got blocked. Semp got it back. Beats it back to the right point to Noah Hull. Noah Hull overskates it. Noah Hull back at the blue line, takes a look, a lot of room, blocks it, a quick chance, and Chirico reached out and blockered that to the corner. Rebound picked up. Bombers work it back out front, looking to go back to Hull, but a great job by Forsberg. He'll redirect this one down the ice, and Hull will go back to get it with 35 seconds to go in the Flin Flon power play. His team ahead 3-1. Here's the pass up the left side. Barreling down the wing. Coming in, a quick chance that time was Vogler. And Chirico out to meet him. He'll throw it to Ashton Paul back of the goal over top of his stick. Puck bounces out front. And the Ice Wolves get a hold of it. Bouncing puck down the ice. 14 seconds to go in the power play. Kenny Marquardt quickly shovels this ahead to Vogler, but too far. Silzer cut it off. Almost had Thomason behind the D. He'll touch it, so they'll blow it offside as he got a hold of it just across the Flin Flon blue line. So 6 seconds to go in the power play. 15:58 remaining here in the second period. It remains a 3-1 Flin Flon lead. Close set to get to 5 aside. The faceoff between Awanis and Tico. Wolves win the draw. That'll do it for the power play. Flin Flon 0-3 here tonight. They go back in their own zone to get it. This is Chichu Laughlin. Had to be careful. Laughlin, good work to get it back to center. Layton couldn't knock it down. That's swept in, and Iwanis will chase after it inside the Wolves zone, bumping with Silzer back in the LaRange net. Iwanis poked it free, got it out front. Laughlin pinched. Puck will come out, but got some help that time from Mueller. Laughlin in the corner for Iwanis. He's got Egan in there with him. Matt Egan in the corner, back to Laughlin at the blue line. His long shot didn't miss by much. A lot of traffic in front of that LaRange net. Puck to blue line, held in here by Tanchuk. Stopped again by Chirico. Back up front, Egan a chance, and he ripped that one wide. Puck comes back to center. Laughlin on top of that one. Boy, Egan had a good opportunity there. Awanis will take the pass. He's away. Down the wing across the Ice Wolves zone, throws that back to Milner. Puck is behind him. Laughlin came over to center, chopped it ahead. Puck will make its way back to Tanchuk, and he tried to hit Awanis with the pass too far. An icing call against Flin Flon. 14:51 remaining here in the second period. Lots of stuff happening out of town here tonight. Argonauts leading the Blue Bombers 14-13 at the half. So Winnipeg's kind of come back. Or 17-13 now at the half. Argo's got a late field goal. Rematch. If you believe that's the only time they're going to play all year.
Wow. Some big wins in soccer too, Rob.
Yes. Today. A big congratulations. I'm glad you brought that up. A big congratulations to Havnut Kings and Queens, the defending zone champions. We'll get back to that momentarily as the Bombers get the puck in. Mueller, Chirico comes out. Mike Slip, of course, commenting about his great stick handling ability. He came up, made a great play there. Took it away from him. Chirico, you could almost argue, almost like a third D-man out there, the way he handles the puck. Wolves will hold it in. Back of the Bomber net, that's Babic. Lost the handle. Flin Flon will poke the blue line, but held in this time by Franz. Franz, a lot of traffic in front. Sends out one in front of the net, and he scores. Traffic galore in front of the Bomber net again. And Franz will get the point shot through. Marquardt had no idea where that puck was.
No, young Pierce Yakimchuk was left his man. He would like to have that shift back there at the end. He sort of lost his man, and he was able to get into Kenny Marquardt's kitchen, and that puck went in. That was a good shot, and here we go, Rob, 3-2.
I told you, never count this LaRange team out.
21-19 shots, too.
And guess what? That's Franz's first goal of the year, so all five goals tonight have been scored by players that have picked up their first of the year. They're giving the goal to Dragon, but Franz was the one that shot it. I don't know why that is, but they struggle with goals in this building. I call games all over the league. I never see them get it wrong as often as they do here. I'm not trying to be critical. It just seems like it happens all the time. Puck is set in front of the LaRange net. They're down a goal, 3-2. The puck is set back towards the Bomber blue line. Franz clearly got that goal. Oh, big hit there. Cassette steps into Bridger. The Bombers want a penalty, and Bridger goes down hard. Somebody comes over after Cassette. I think it's Bourgeois, the Bomber defender, or Joey Lees, pardon me. Holy cow, did Cassette ever step into him? And no chance for Britcher to get out of the way there. Do you think that should have been a penalty there, Mike?
I don't know. I think he got Liam in the... He was in the railroad tracks and...
Yeah, he got just in a real bad spot on the ice. The good news is that he's up.
It was a big hit, though.
I give Liam Britcher a lot of credit to get up from that.
Yeah.
But the Wolves, everything going their way right now. They get the goal with less than a second remaining in the period. They score early, and a big thundering body check here.
Referees are having a chat down by the penalty box. So is Justin Lee.
Here's the replay on it right now, Mike. So you're going to have... I don't think that's a penalty.
No, I don't either. Mike, the only thing is how high did he get him? But
well, I know it looked like he hit him right in the chest area.
Yeah, here we go again.
I mean, look at this replay here. Like, it does not look like a hit to the head to me.
No, I
think that's a legal hit from what I can tell.
I think so. I think that's how it.
Like you said, he's just in a real bad spot. But he's getting a penalty. That might not be for that though. There's a lot of stuff that happened after that.
Yeah, and Joey Lee's is going to the box.
Well, he stuck up for his teammate. I got no problem with that.
Absolutely what he should do.
Anyway, looking at, we mentioned the Argonauts up 17-13 in the Blue Bombers at the half. That's quite the score considering that half the Toronto team isn't even playing tonight. Baseball scores. The Blue Jays hoping to get to the postseason. Last time we checked, they were doing well, and... They're up 11-4 now, the Blue Jays are in the seventh inning, so a good mighty Tampa Bay is resting a lot of guys tonight as well. And that very well could be a playoff preview.
Yeah, absolutely. We got offsetting penalties, Rob.
That'll be the roughs after the whistle.
Yep.
Other scores pertaining to that? Astros and Diamondbacks haven't started yet. They need to run the table, I think. And Mariners, Texas later tonight as well. Anyway, the Ice Wolves have pulled within a goal.
Liam Britcher looks okay on the bench there.
Like
Rob.
I said, I give a lot of credit for getting up after he got hit hard there. Graham trying to keep the puck in. Here's Bukart in the front of that. Bukart walks in, he scores! Undresses Kenny Marquardt. And just like that, it's a 3-3 game, and the Bomber defense has not made any changes.
No, that was...
Marquardt walked right around him.
That wasn't very good. Here's the replay on that goal, Rob. He
just grabbed the puck and walked right in past everybody and made a really good move on Kenny Marquardt.
Just wanted that puck more than the Bomber defenseman did, and... He was able to make the move on Kenny.
Burkhart's second of the night, and we mentioned that goal. Again, that could come down to the turning point of the hockey game. The Wolves scoring that goal with less than a second remaining in the first period.
Absolutely.
Ice Wolves have made it interesting at 3-3 and have taken all the momentum here in the second period. And Flin Flon defensively tonight has just not been good. Burkhart again across the line. Trying to get free. Lost a handle. Here comes Silvestri. Silvestri will get a shot away. Graham, they get a goal. Here's a freebie for Marquardt. As it jumps out front, and he'll jam it in. And that's a bad giveaway by the Ice Wolves back in their own net. And holy cow, it's loud in here tonight. The puck took a funny hop.
Off the board.
And again, out of the four goals that Flin Flon scored tonight, Chirico again was not set for that shot.
No. I sat with Kenny Marquardt and Laser Hume the other night. They were evaluating goaltenders for minor hockey. And they were pointing at the part, the boards, at each spot where you can get some great bounces or bad bounces, depending on what team. And that's exactly what happened there. And it was one of the spots they showed me that.
So Vakler gets his second of the night. This might be an unassisted goal. Handle will kick that towards the front. And Marquardt not going to take any chances as he's going to cover up. With 13:02 to play here in the second period. We'll see if there's an assist added on that. Silvestri gets one. So Jacob Vakler gets his second of the game. Silvestri and Houle, who've had good games as well, will get the assist. And it's 4-3 Flin Flon, and you almost get that river hockey mentality. We might end up with like a 9-8 hockey game here tonight.
I was just thinking the exact same thing.
The way that they're free rolling, and here they go again. Chance up the left side. The Bombers will get it underneath. Walker, he tried to toe drag, came back close to getting it alone. Good job by Franz D-man to hold it back. Here comes Silvestri to the middle of the ice. Dropped it back. Bourgeois, shot, big save, rebound, loose puck to catch. hockey game. Well, he's been able to jump up on the play with these guys and almost looks like a forward out there tonight playing with Vockler and Sylvester, but Bourgeois gets it in. They have the open net, but I'm not sure what defenseman it was for the Wolves, but he cleared that puck just in the nick of time.
Absolutely. Jacob Vockler's flying out there right now. He just jumped up into that play like a lightning bolt, and as you say, Mr. Bourgeois having a really nice game. He hasn't played the regular season game. I think he's been injured. So
I think he was. Anyway, a face-off back in the ice. Wolves zone. They're trying to decide who's going to take the draw. Noah Holt, the defenseman's going to go in to take the face-off. Not sure about that. I guess he wanted to. Anyway, they win the draw. Bombers try to work that one back out front. That's Ashton Paul back of the goal. An assist tonight. Gets it back to blue line. Bourgeois won't shoot it. DePaul, it redirects him and offs him and comes back to the Bomber blue line. Ashton Paul with a guy on him. Dropped it back. A good play. Picked up here by Piccinino. Feeds it to center ice. This is Noah Hull. Trying to come back out front to Paul, but that's intercepted here by Graham, who got an assist on the last LaRange goal. And he'll quickly dump this off to Taylor. Taylor takes off up the wing across the Bomber line. He'll carry it in. Big hit there as he and Noah Hull collide. Loose puck held in by Foster at the blue line. This is Taylor along the wall. Bourgeois knocked it away from him, made a good defensive play. That's what you got to do. Got to be physical at your own end. Piccinino takes the pass to center. Piccinino across the line, a quick shot, and stopped here by Chirico. He thought about clearing it, but he'll hang on as Piccinino will make his way to the front of the LaRange den. So 4-3, Flint Flon leads at 11.5 to go. The shot's dead even at 22 apiece.
Piccinino has had a nice period here, too, to start offensively. He's looked very good.
Out of town in the SJHL tonight, Wayward Estevan 2-2 heading into the second. Nipawin, a 5-1 lead on Kindersley late in the opening period. Yorkton leads North Battleford again tonight, 3-2. They beat them 8-4 last night. And no score in Melfort between the Hounds and Mustangs. There's a big hit from the Melfort, from the LaRange bench. And Owanis will carry in over the LaRange net. Had Egan and Miller cutting to the front of the net. Puck bounces, picked up by Owanis. He scores! Off the crossbar and in!
The shooting gallery, Rob.
Bad play attempt there by the ice wall. And the Bombers have caught them a couple times in their own zone. Nonchalant. The Wolves, again, we're getting all his offensive chances. And then Flint Flon gets a couple chances in tight. Couldn't get the puck out of Wanis, so give him credit. As soon as it was on his stick, he let a rip. And he's got his first of the year as well. And Flint Flon back in front, 5-3. And the goals continue to come fast and furious tonight here, Mike Schlepp.
We've said it a lot, but it isn't a defensive gem out there for either team.
Ice rolls right off the faceoff, trying to come back and answer. The puck is back in the Flint Flon zone, and that'll be cleared up over the glass and out of play.
The assist to number 26, Brock Mueller.
Mueller will get an assist, and Matt Egan will get a second assist.
8:22.
So holy cow, looked like the ice wolves were flying high. It kind of had the Bombers getting buried, but a couple of goals again and retake the momentum. And I don't think if you can be a fan tonight and leave your seat, you're going to miss something. 11:18 to go, second period. A 5-3 Flint Flon lead. Tokic will take the faceoff here against Jacob Vockler. Big game for Vockler tonight, including a pair of goals. To Silvestri. Back to Vockler. Oh, he almost made that quick move again. That's the second time that Franz has made a good play to take it away from. Otherwise, he's gone.
Ooh.
Vockler take it down, a brief 2-on-1. Silvestri out front. Here's a chance. He scores! Skaglin! The magic continues! 6-3, and we've got a goalie change. Skaglin continues his mastery here in the early part of the season, and Chirico's night is done, and the Bombers will chase him as they make it a 6-3 hockey game here early in the second period. A picture-perfect shot over top of his left shoulder. And wow, like I said, if you're a fan, how can you get up and even go for popcorn in the bathroom?
No,
you're going to miss something.
Trevor Stenglin with just a great shot. Boy, that guy has had a nice start to his Bomber career.
Fourth of the year to lead the team.
Yeah. You know, we said the Bombers weren't playing great defensively, like I said just a few minutes ago. LeRon just looked awful defensively here.
Well, they're not getting any saves right now either. Chance a foot bomb gets, they're scoring. But again, we're not even at the midway part of the hockey game yet, Mike.
Nope.
11-1 to go in the second period. Steglin scores his team-leading fourth of the year. And it's 6-3 Flin Flon. Rocker races in there looking for more. Puck at the side of the ice goal. That's grabbed here by Foster. Can he get it out? Who will keep it in? A shot on target. That bounces away from Rat. So Silvestri and Iwanis will get the assist. Flin Flon holds it in. At the blue line, there's a long shot. That one knocked away by Rat, who apparently played professional hockey last year. So he's no slouch coming in relief tonight. Bulls get it back to center. Silzer quickly across the... Bobby Lyon gets dicked here. Nice body check that time by Bourgeois. Boy, Bourgeois is having himself one heck of a hockey game. Second big hit for him tonight. Sepp will take the pass. He's across the line. Looks like the Iceville player is shaken up. Slow to get to the bench. There's a chance for Silvestri. Didn't miss that one by much. Then he gets decked here. Semph after it. Semph back of the goal. Gets tagged him here. The puck's at the blue line. Hull can't hold it in. Noah Hull back to center. Carries the puck in across to LeRon's line. Here goes Noah Hull. Tried to throw that one back out front. Semph couldn't get to it. Puck lifted back to center. Here's Chichu Laughlin. Laughlin moves that ahead. Semph down the wing. Cuts in a shot. Rock the save. Rebound is loose in front of LeRon's net. They try to get to it, but it's picked up here by Layton. Layton back to center. Knocked away that time by Laughlin. Quickly picked up here by Piccinino. Piccinino, a good move. Piccinino! Can he face Laughlin after it? And we got a penalty coming up. I thought Laughlin might get his first career SHL goal. But a good save there.
Carl Sonoff.
Actually, it's not Cale Radonet. It's 31, I think.
Carl Sonoff, Rob.
Okay.
Yeah. Boy, Piccinino has had a nice game. The Bombers all of a sudden with a little smart, well, a lot of smart, and Jacob Bockler has a firecracker in his pants. He's flying out there.
6-3 Flin Flon leads it just past the midway point of the hockey game.
Penalty.
Yeah, who would have thought that there'd be all kinds of action? A media timeout. Flin Flon going back on the power play, by the way, for the fourth time tonight, and maybe this will be the chance that they finally get that elusive power play goal.
Yeah, yeah, that's the, right now, that's what the only thing missing offensively is power play goals.
So Carl Sonoff is the goaltender from Edmonton. He comes in relief of Topher Chirico, who, of course, is the backup last year, Dawson Smith, and held him in, made some good saves in the opening period, but the second period, this stuff wasn't able to get to him, and I'm sure if I was to say to anybody that he'd give up six goals before the midway point of the hockey game, but I don't think anybody would have believed that.
No, absolutely not. He hadn't had his best night, but I'm sure the young man will rebound.
But, again, in his defense, I mean, it hasn't exactly been a defensive struggle.
Oh, no.
They set the tone early. They're going up and down the ice. This is like almost like a glorified exhibition game. Flip-flop's starting to hit a little bit now, but I mean, they're going down and forth. But this is a river, this is pond hockey.
It is. You mentioned Bourgeois. He's thrown some big hits out there. Excuse me, and it's looked fantastic, too.
So the face-off back inside the Wolves zone. It's 6-3 Flin-Flon. Flin-Flon on the power play for the fourth time tonight, looking for their first power play goal here. Here's a chance for Bakker. He fanned on that one. Puck is picked up by Graham. Can't clear. Bakker holds it in. Justin Lees. Back to Hull. Back to Lees. He's covered. Can't shoot it. Lees will hang on. Looking for some room. Back to Hull. His chance. Nice job that time by Thomas to block it. Orange does block a lot of shots. Very good penalty-killing team. Flin Flon works it back to Bakker at the point. He'll hang on to it. Back of the goal, it goes to Silvestri. Back to the point to Hull. Hull. For Silvestri. Back to Hull. A quick chance. Deflected. Bakker scores. It's the hat-trick. And that's the first power play goal of the year. And here come the hats. Where's your hat? Jacob Bakker converts the hat-trick. Northland 4, the perfect opportunity. Could have had Northland 4 hats here tonight. And we would have littered. Tell Allison that you're going to do that every time there's a hat trick. We're going to litter the ice with Northland 4 hats. You like the idea?
Yeah, I love the idea. I don't know if Allison will.
You don't get better advertising than that, Mike. Come on.
There's a couple of nice bomber hats out there. has had a great second period. And
well, he's got three goals and counting. We still have 8:47 to play here in the second period. A 7-3 Flin Flon lead in that one. He just got out front and redirected it in. And that's the first power play goal of the season for the Bombers, too. So we'll see if that kind of takes the weight off their shoulders a little bit.
Tough for Karlsson to come in.
Knocked out by Laughlin, quickly away. He's across to Laurent's line, gets it back. Mueller fed on that one. He'll get it in deep, throws it back out front. Flintstone comes close again. And Foster converts the hat trick. We're getting the announcement here as Foster will take off across the Bomber line. Poole gets the lone assist. Icelows get it in deep. So Noah Hull will get his second assist of the game. And the Ice Wolves score. And I think that's Bukart that tipped that one in, and that could be his hat-trick goal. Bukart out front, redirected, and that, and he's got a hat-trick tonight for the Wolves.
No,
the offense continues.
One. That one is kind of like a knuckleball. I think you're right, Rob. It was probably tipped.
But he got credit for it.
Kenny.
You're listening for the assist, trying to get caught up, and boy, they go boom and score down the other way. I can't remember seeing a game like this. Have you?
No. Kenny reached high, and it went underneath. It changed directions on him for sure.
So the Ice Wolves are back in it. Bukart will convert the hat trick here tonight. Forsberg. And here come the Wolves again. Bukart again cutting in. Batted away in midair that time. And Flin Flon will get it back to center. Forsberg and Dragon get the assists. We're going to be here forever counting down these goals at the end of the second period. 7-4, Flin Flon leads it, 8:05 to go in the period. Pass up the right side, and that's grabbed here by Joey Lees. Trying to throw that out front. Good to see Bridger back on the ice. First time we've seen him since he took that big hit from Cassette. We haven't seen much of Cassette since I body check either.
No.
Handel's got it at center for the Wolves. He'll bank it in. Along the wall, Noah Hull knocked it down. Throws it back of the goal, racing over there to get it. It's Yakimchuk. Yakimchuk up to Lees, clears it back to center. Graham cut that one off. Here's Cassette. Speaking of Cassette, there he is, across the line. Dropped it back, a quick chance that time, fired on target. Rebound, they score! No, Cassette! That's a second goal waved off here. They're going to say that Cassette hit it in with a hand. Cassette says he hit it in with a stick, but the referee says no. Love to get a replay. Here's the replay. We'll see for ourselves. See if you can watch it from this angle. I can't tell, Mike. That's too far away.
Yeah, Cassette, if he did hit it with his hand, but I think his argument is that he hit it with his hand to his stick. I couldn't see it.
The replay is just way too far off.
Yeah, for up here, it looked like it was his hand, but I don't know where that puck went to after he put it back
well,
up on the ice.
I will say this, the referee was standing right there.
Yeah, and immediately called it
off.
Yeah,
absolutely. Boy, that close to being 7-5, 7:19 to go. The shots are 30-24, Flin Flon. It might be the last team that gets a shot tonight that wins this hockey game. We've already had a goaltending change. As the Ice Wolves have yanked Chirico in aid of Sonoff, like we said, who does have some professional experience here. Laughter for the blue line. He rips that on target, and Sonoff will stop that. We got Walker, who's got a hat trick tonight, gets hammered in the crease. They're not going to like him standing in front of the net. And, boy, neither team defensively tonight has been able to have an answer so far.
There's been some rough stuff in front of that Laurent bench. And also the Bomber net in the first period there. The boys are going at it with Kenny Marquardt laying on the bottom of a pile. But it's entertaining, Rob. If nothing else, it's an entertaining game.
Well, we'll see what happens. Steglin, who's got a goal, takes the faceoff of the Wolves zone. Laurent quickly wins it. They get it back to center. Dragon will flip it in. A couple of assists for him tonight. Bourgeois. He's got a goal. Can't clear that one out. Puck is bouncing. Grabbed here by Wachler. Moves it ahead to Silvestri. Great move there. Silvestri quickly across the line. Silvestri rips that over top. And then he had Steglin coming from the goal as well. Laughlin trying to hold it in. He thought he was going to get a goal the last time he was out there, and so did I. Got to a really good position in front of the net. Puck bounces. Wolves get it. They'll try to skate it out. This is Baldwin, the center. Fights off a check by Steglin. He'll dump it in. Puck goes back to the Bomber net and grabbed and hung on to here by Marquardt, and more pushing and shoving behind the net. And these orange jerseys are tough. tough to see this real the side numbers. I think that's Ashton Paul. No, sorry, that's
Bourgeois.
So 6:20 to go in the second period. 32-24 the shots in favor of Flint Pond. And the Bombers a 7-4 lead. They were up quickly 3-0. Wolves came back to tie it. And the Bombers were able to jump out 6-3. The Wolves made it interesting, and now it's 7-4. Here's Justin Lees. Believe it or not, doesn't have a point in this game. Over to Ashton Paul. Down the right side. Shoveled that one in, but Thomas will grab it here for the Wolves, and he'll start to skate away. Coming over, taking away from him is from Pinacino. Pinacino never quits, boy. To Ashton Paul along the boards. Paul has got it. He'll hang on to it. In the corner for Pinacino. Throws it through traffic out the side of the net. Poked back of the goal. Justin Lees is after it. Justin Lees keeps it in. Here's Ashton Paul. Dumps that one off. Knocked down by Tanchuk. One-timer fired on target that time. A good job by Yakupchuk. And the Iceville goaltender Soloff stopped him. Good puck possession by Flint Flon deep inside LaRange territory. Ashton Paul back of the goal. This is Ashton Paul. Back up front to Yakupchuk. Tanchuk, long shot, deflects off target. Yakupchuk will try to hold it in. Puck stays in. Yakupchuk, bouncing puck, knocked it down, but it comes back to center. Chipped inside the Bomber zone that time by Babic, and Tanchuk goes back to get it. This might be the longest sequence we've gone all night without a goal. Poked ahead to Paul. He can't pick it up. Puck will go up into the Bomber bench and blown down with 4:58 remaining in the second period. What a game here tonight. 7-4 the score in favor of Flint Flon. A four-point night for Jacob Bachler. Alexi Silvestri tonight. He's got himself a nice game. He's got a goal and a couple of assists. And a number of players have picked up their first goal of the year on both teams.
Yeah, absolutely.
Lugart, his first three goals, a hat-trick for LaRange. Face off outside the Flint Flon line. Matt Egan, an assist tonight. He gets stopped. Wolves will fire it in. Kenny Marcourt stopped it back of the goal. Bombers get it back. Shipped out that time by Matt Egan. Franz goes back to get it. Try to come back to Bukart. Watch him. He's had the hot hand. He's got it. Partial 2-on-1. Bukart down the wing. Out front to handle. Puck bounce. He couldn't knock it down cleanly. Noah Hull back of his own net. Trying to get the puck up the ice. He'll bounce it off the boards. Franz knocked it down just inside the LaRange blue line. Feeds it over to Graham. Back to center ice to handle to Forsberg. Forsberg across the Bomber line, dumped it in. Here's Bourgeois. He'll knock it down. Plays it ahead to Hull. Hull, a terrific game again tonight. Feeds it back. Bourgeois jumps into the play, shoots it. Soloff was looking behind him, but I think it hit somebody and directed wide. Matt Egan back of the goal. To the blue line, held in by Iwanis. He's got a goal tonight, but that one tapped away. They almost had Taylor off to the races. Passes a little bit too far. An icing call against LaRange. And
boy, Fabrice Bourgeois has had a nice first game. He's thrown some huge hits. Jumped up in the play, nearly got his second goal of the night there, Rob.
Yeah, he's been jumping up in the play lots.
And made some really nice hits and played with a bit of an edge.
He certainly has. The Bombers win the faceoff. This is Chichu Laughlin, just keeps it in. 4 points for Silvestri tonight, a goal and three assists. There's a chance from an off angle, and Joey Lee's looking for his second of the year. Cohen Semph is out front, and Soloff will stop that. So we're waiting for the big line to get going tonight. Caught up with Cole McCaig earlier today, the acting bench boss, with Mike Reagan off with the Alberta Junior Showcase, and said there was certainly looking forward to see what the top line can do. And
they've
eight points combined for Vockler and Silvestri.
You knew you weren't going to keep them off the score sheet for long.
Another face-off win. Tanchuk, a long shot. Bridger in there trying to knock that one down. Puck will come to the blue line. Lee's held it in, but it hit a body. Came back to Bridger. He's got it quickly across the line. Bridger can move. Good work along the wall. The blue line. Back to Chichu Laughlin. Long shot. Sauna stopped that big. Rebound kicked out front. Cassette. Reaching up and keeping that one in was Liam Bridger, and that will get the fans jumping out of their seats as he'll throw that one back in deep. Back of the goal, Silzer. Got it over there for Foster. Can't clear. To the line, Tanchuk scores! His first of the year! And the Wolves track corner comes back to the blue line. And Cole Tanchuk's got his first of the season. 8-4 Flint Pond, Mike Schlipp. The goals continue to come fast and furious. Could go down as a historic here at the Whitney for
crazy,
Paul Tkachuk. Nice call, first of the year.
Liam Bridger did a great job on the blue line.
He leaped up there and kept that
bucket. He looked like a young Ozzie Smith at shortstop for the St. Louis Cardinals there. He leaped up. He really got some vertical there, Rob.
Well, he was the key to that goal for sure. Yeah. Made a terrific play to keep it in. So Paul Tkachuk gets his first of the year. And the Bombers are back up 8-4. And again, the goal's coming fast and furious here. Hopefully Bridger gets an assist on that, because he was the key.
And number 16,
yep. Liam Bridger. Semph and Bridger, the assist football. Coming back, looking for more. They dish it out front. Puck is loose. Sylvester trying to jam it in here. I don't know how that one even stayed out.
On 16:57.
Boy, they had the goaltender Sonoff tied up at the side of the post. The puck was laying there. How did that stay out? Boole will pinch it. I'm going to need a sheet of paper. Can you believe this? I got one line left. We're going to have to get the second sheet out here for more goals. 8-4, Flin Flon in front. 2:19 to go in the second period. This is Baldwin for the Wolves at center. He'll get it back. That backhander didn't miss by much. Rebound chipped out front. Marquardt's got that. He'll hang on. 2:08 to go in the second period. Is it me? Or has this been a really long second period?
Well, they have to stop to have faceoff for all the goals, Rob. You know, you said it's like pond hockey. Yeah, it's like playing road hockey on Phelan Avenue. It's scrappy, it's scrambly, but it's entertaining.
Yeah, fans like goals, right? Foster gets that one through. Big rebound kicked up by Marquardt. Wolves can't jump on it. Piccinino does. Piccinino takes off at center, and his backhander on target gets his own rebound, but it comes right back out front. They'll feed it back to Laughlin. Can't hold it in. Comes back to center. Tkachuk, who's got a goal. He reps that on target. Save is made. Rebound picked up here by Franz at the side of the LaRange net. 12 goals in this game, if you can believe it. Thomas to center. Back to Babic. Dropped it back. Here's Tokic, a shot. That went over top of the Bomber net. Piccinino hit hard along the board, poked it ahead. Lees swats this one over to Laughlin. Gets it to Ashton Paul. Paul knocks his guy down at center. Ashton Paul can't pick up the loose puck, but Lees does. Lees down the wing. Trying to get a shot away, didn't get much wood on it. He'll grab his own rebound back of the ice wall net. Here's Justin Lees. Back out front, picture perfect pass. No, a hole, a shot. And Sona stopped that. Who will hit hard back of the goal? He goes down. Acrobatic style, but right back up. And the Wolves, Thomas gets it to center and dumps it inside the Flin Flon zone. Justin Lees will pick it up back of the Bomber net. Played that one ahead to Ashton Paul. Bumped off the puck. Loose puck picked up by Iwanis. Iwanis in behind it. He's got Lees out front. Had to shovel it to him, but coming over to cut him off that time was Graham. Here's Forsberg. 40 seconds to go in the period. Dropped it back. A hard drive. Sails over top of the net that time by Layton. Bombers back on the attack. Here comes Matt Egan. Barreling across the ice. Dropped it back. Iwanis, a shot. Big left pad save there. Kick right out front to Bourgeois. Bourgeois dancing back of the LaRange net. Will hang on to it. Layton gets to it. Flipped to the line. Egan races up, or reaches up and keeps it in. Now it comes out. Egan gets it back. 14 seconds to go. Wheeler trying to get free. Swatted away from him. Here's Forsberg. Outside the zone, back to center, grabbed by Tkachuk. He'll tap it in this very interesting, entertaining second period is going to come to an end. As Egan gets a shot away in the period. Is Egan going to get a penalty for that?
No, I think that the Ice Wolf is going to get a slash.
Yep. You're right, it is. Boy, Mike, you're on your game tonight.
Uh-oh. And I think something else happened here. Maybe,
Well, the Bombers didn't quit. The puck was back in LaRange net. The Ice Wolf defenseman grabbed it. And then Egan grabbed it, tried the wraparound as the buzzer had went. And I thought maybe they might give him a penalty, but probably too close to call that one.
Rob, I'm going to sit down and listen to you do the recap. It should be done by the start of the third period.
Holy cow, I can't. Football's got 40 shots now. They had 24 shots in that
period.
In that second period.
I think they might call that penalty.
Five goals.
For shooting the puck late. Yeah, I think they're going to.
Unsportsmanlike. All righty, well, let's get this before we take a break. The second period scoring summary. We talked about it in depth, Mike, about how that late goal in the opening period might spark the Wolves. Well, it certainly did to start the period. as they come out, Bookcourt would get a goal, a power play goal, actually. That was on that five-minute major. He scored that one. I guess it would have been at the early in. Bookcourt would get it. His first of the year from Taylor, so that would make it a... that's still the first goal. The second period, here we go. Franz gets the goal unassisted. That was after the 5 minute had expired. That came at the 5:15 mark, so it was 3-2. Then Bookcourt would get his second. Graham the assist at 6:34. That would tie things up. Looked like the Ice Wolves had things going their way, but then Jacob Bakker took care of business again. Gives the Bombers the lead with his second tonight. Sylvester and Boole the assist at 6:49. Bailey Iwanis comes up with a big goal. His first of the year from Mueller and Egan at 8:22. 6-3, this would chase the starting netminder tonight. Topher Chirico. And then Stengel would get a picture-perfect pass. He loves to shoot the puck high.
Yeah.
Over top of the left shoulder, that time of the Ice Wolf netminder. Sylvester and Iwanis assisting at 8:54. Flip-flop well in front at that point, 6-3. They'd make it 7-3. Vakker converting the hat trick. Power play goal. Flint Flon's first power play of the year. Boole the assist on that one at 11:13. They shot the puck in front. Boole, or Vakker redirected it to convert the hat trick. Then Bukart comes back to get the hat trick. A nice deflection out front. Would make the score at that point 7-4. And then Tamchuk, the Bomber defenseman, gets the puck. The Ice Wolves couldn't clear it. He picked it up along the left-hand boards. Fired him on target quickly to beat the new netminder tonight, Carl Sauna. Senf and Bridger, the assist on that one at 16:57. And again, it was Liam Bridger that was the key to that one. Leaping up in the air, knocking it down, and allowing Flint Flon to keep the puck in, and allowing Paul Tamchuk to eventually take advantage and get his first goal of the year.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know what to say about that period, Rob. It was super exciting. Some big hits, some great goals, no defense. It was good. Rob, I just want to mention we got some offsetting penalties to start the third. They did call Matt Egan for, unsportsmanlike, yeah, for shooting the puck after the whistle.
So shots in that period, 24-10 in favor of Flint Flon. The Bombers out shooting the Wolves down 40-27 through 40 minutes of play, and both teams are 1-for-4 on the power play. But some big nights tonight. Jacob Bakker, 4 points. He's got another career hat trick. I think he had two of them last year. So he's got another one here early this year. Alexei Silvestri having a terrific night. He's got 4 points. Of course, we mentioned Steglin now leads the team with 4 goals. He had 3 in the opening weekend. He gets a big goal tonight. Bourgeois has had himself a pretty nice hockey game, and a number of players getting their first goal of the season here in this game.
Yeah, although Piccinino hasn't got a goal, I think he's got at least one assist, but he's all over the ice, and boy, Ashton Paul has had a nice nice first game as a Flint Flon Bomber.
Got an assist tonight on the Bourgeois goal.
Liam Bridger with the recipient of a monster hit and came back and made a nice play, like you say.
He's actually been skating very well in this game as well.
Yeah, he has.
Anyway, that's the story so far. 8-4 Flint Flon. What's going to happen in the third period? I don't know, but I wouldn't go anywhere. Action fast at first. And, of course, these two teams got to do it again tomorrow night in LaRange.
Yeah, yeah. It'll be interesting to see what happens. I was going to say, I hope it doesn't get out of hand and we get some rough stuff. But I don't think either team can afford it because the goals are going in left, right, and center. It's still not over.
No, it's not. 8-4 Flint Flon leads it. Before we take a break, we'll just recap some out-of-town scores. Weaver and Estevan 2-2 midway through the second. Nipwood a big 6-1 lead on Kindersley in the second period. Yorkton and Battleford are tied up at 3. That's after 1. And Melfort's got a 3-0 lead on Notre Dame late in the opening period. We'll take a break. The third period for Flow TV coming up momentarily. wild second period. The Bombers out shooting the Ice Wolves 24-10. 40-27 is the count. 8-4 is the score. They've already had a goaltending change, and boy, it'll be interesting to see what happens here in the third. Again, if you're the Wolves, the way that the game's gone, I think you got to go with the same game plan you had. Try and get a goal here right off the hop and try and keep coming because, again, both teams have kind of left defense out the window so far tonight.
Yeah, I don't think you want to change anything if you're – although, I mean, the Bombers did take it to them halfway through that period. And just some great hits in that period, in the game so far on both sides. Start off 4-on-4 here, Rob.
Yeah, those penalties that happened right at the end of the period with Matt Egan. Here's Bukar. He scores! 5 seconds into the period. That's the fourth goal of the night for Bukar. And holy cow, right off the faceoff, Mike Slippy gets in and he beats Kenny Marcourt top right shelf. And again, this game far from over. It's all of a sudden a three-goal game again. Burkhardt's had the hot hand tonight, his fourth of the game. 5 seconds into the third period.
Yeah, Kenny would like that one back, I think. I don't. So yeah, it's crazy. Burkhardt, four goals.
I think that's an unassisted goal. I think he won the faceoff and went flying in.
I think you're right.
Here comes the announcement. So Bukart's fourth of the year. Well, Forsberg would have taken the draw, so he would have got it. And it's official. I'm now on my second sheet of paper for goals. 8-5. Here's Piccinino racing across the line. Gets it back to Hull. Look out, poked away. Forsberg got a partial break. Forsberg across the line. He gets a shot away. Didn't miss by much. Puck came right back out front. Piccinino will take off. He's got Hull with him. Piccinino down the wing will carry the puck in. Piccinino back of the goal, hangs on to it, tried to come back out front. He had Stakeland open, but couldn't get it to him. At the blue line, Bourgeois thought about dishing it off, but there was nobody to give it to. Bukart's got it. Quick pass to Forsberg. Forsberg by himself. The line is changing. Forsberg will bring it in. Runs it to Townchuk. Puck grabbed here by Bourgeois. Franz picked that one off. And look out, here comes Hodge across the line. Flipped it out front. He had a wide open net to Forsberg. He's tied up, and no doubt about this one. And I'll tell you what, there's bad penalties, Mike Slip, and good penalties.
Yeah.
That's a good penalty by Ashton Paul. If he doesn't tie his guy up, it's 8-6.
Yeah, absolutely. Ashton Paul got the hook on the Ice Wolf and then saved a goal. Absolutely.
He was wide open. I'll tell you what, Kenny Marcourt's going to have to bear down a little bit here in this third period.
Yeah, it's tough.
You can see he's kind of fighting it a little bit there, Mike, just to even how he's, I don't know if he's maybe injured something, but he looks really, he's standing very awkwardly in the Bomber crease there. And reacted very late to that shot that by Forsberg that didn't miss by much. So the Wolves are 1-for-4 on the power play, get a chance to make it a two-goal game once again as Cassette will get it in deep. Back out front to Hodge. Hodge, Layton, side of the goal. Oh, that one was close to going in. Marcourt just got enough of it. They'll get it back out front to Layton. Shoots it. Save made. Puck is loose in front of the Bomber net. They can't clear. Cassette after it. Knocked that one away from Silvestri. Puck took a funny hop. They couldn't get to it. Back to Layton at the blue line. Throws that back out front to Bukart, who's already got four tonight. Back out to Layton. Layton to the blue line. Shoots it. That over top of that. Marcourt didn't even blink. He didn't see it. Good job by the Ice Wolves to screen the front of the net. Layton, top of the right circle here for Cassette. Hangs on, shoots it. That's off the side of the net. Boy, the Bombers can't get anything on this one. Back to Egan's back out there. Here's a chance in front of good save that time by Kenny Marcourt. And the puck is set down the ice. A minute to go in the Ice Wolf power play. That one, the goaltender couldn't get in sync with the rest of the team. The Bombers will get it back at their own blue line. Bourgeois sets up Bachler. Bachler with a hat trick tonight. He gets a quick chance and sets that one over top of the Ice Wolf net. Bridger in there as well. Good work by him to try and pin it up and kill some time. Excellent job by Liam Bridger. Continues to work hard. They do dig it free. Pass behind Handel. He'll come back and get it at his blue line. And he feeds it back to Franz. Franz has got a goal here tonight. As a matter of fact, his goal did come on the power play. 25 seconds to go on the Ice Wolf power play. Here's Franz. Too far, cut off at the Bomber blue line by Hull and hammered down on target. Stop made by Sonoff. On the ice, also trying to get it back across the Bomber line. This is Noah Hull breaking that one up, sending it back in. 8 seconds to go in the Lorange power play. Sonoff will play to the corner, picked up by Franz. Franz will flip it ahead. Grabbed here by Gary. He gets it in tight. Penalty is over. Ashton Paul out of the box. The puck goes aside the Flin-Flon net and grabbed here by the Bomber netminder, Kenny Marquardt. But wow, 5 seconds into the period, Bucourt's got his fourth goal in the hockey game. What a performance by him.
13 goals between the two teams tonight, Rob. As you say, you filled up a sheet. You ever do that before?
Not in a long time.
Yeah.
5-1, LaRange out shooting Flin-Flon, by the way, so far in this third period. 8-5 is the score in favor of the Bombers. A monstrous second period here tonight. And they're taking all day and all night to drop the puck.
Yeah, that's a referee's fault there.
Well, the linesman.
Linesman's fault, yeah.
Like, again, it's not rocket science. Just drop it. Here's Mueller. Trying to come back up the middle to Iwanis. That's cut off at center ice here by Foster. He'll hammer it back in. There's Laughlin. That puck got redirected. The Wolves keep it in. LaRange coming up with a pretty good game plan. They're going at the Bomber defense hard here in this third period. Laughlin whipped on it again. Falls down. Taylor along the boards. He's had some good moments in this game, trying to pin it up here. Flin-Flon trying to dig it free. Puck laying there. Mueller knocked to the ice. The puck comes to Matt Egan. Egan trying to get free at center. Foster takes it from him. Foster quickly across the Bomber line. Spins, fires, shoots it on target. Save made. Puck comes right back out front. Here's Babic. He fanned on it. Wolves will hold it in there. Been in control here so far in this third period. Flin-Flon kind of a step back. They've tremendous second period, like we indicated, out shooting the Wolves 24-10, but the Wolves are taking it to them so far. That one is fired up over the glass by Tokic. And 15:44 to go, 41-32 the shots. So 6-1, LaRange leading the shot brigade so far in the third. And I think I can speak for everybody in this building. Nobody thinks that that lead is safe.
No. Which is crazy.
Flin-Flon wins the faceoff. This is Joey Lees quickly to center. Throws that one over top of LaRange. That puck leg at the back of the ice won't go. They try to dig it free, but stays on the netting. They'll blow it down. So we'll get our first faceoff in the LaRange zone so far in the third period. As, or will we? It looks like the puck's going to come outside the zone. So Semp, Lees and Britcher will go back to work on this faceoff just outside the LaRange blue line. Semp lining up for the faceoff as he lines up against Bellshill. Center ice. Baldwin's got it. Bouncing puck set inside the Flin-Flon zone. Noah Hull waited for it. Up the boards. Can't clear it. Back down. Off the glove that time of Marquardt. A good quick shot that time by Silzer. I'm thinking both these teams, if they have any opportunity to shoot the puck, they're going to take it with the amount of pucks that have gone in here tonight. Wolves will hammer it back in. Picked up that time by the Bomber and D-man Yakimchuk. He gets it to center. Lees, a quick pass. Here's Bridger. His hard drive didn't miss by much. Looking low glove hand here on Sonoff. Puck rolls back to center. Picked up by Yakimchuk, and he'll send it in. Knocked down the side of the ice. Will goal by Franz. Rams played that one up the middle. Takes its way back in the Flin-Flon zone. Townshik, who's got a goal tonight, knocked it down. They'll move it to Silvestri at center. Silvestri hammers that one in. Bakker can't catch up with a puck will roll back the Bomber blue line. Townshik is there. Feeds it back to Bourgeois. To Townshik in his own zone. Don't forget, these orange jerseys that the Bombers are wearing in honor of Truth and Reconciliation will be all auctioned off after this hockey game tonight. Would you like to get one of these sweaters for your very own?
I would.
Get the opportunity.
I was talking to Allison Cooper, and we both thought they were really, really nice.
Bucart drops it back to Franz. A big hit there. Flin-Flon gets it back. They can't clear it. Nice job by Bucart to knock it down. He's got a goal early in the third period to give his team life once again. He's got four of the Ice Wolf five goals in this game. Can't grab that one. Forsberg gets a chance. He whipped on it. And that's picked up here by Brockler to center. Walker will backhander inside the Wolves zone. Franz is there, cleared along the boards, knocked away. Chance here for Paul. He tried the toe drag, but Franz stayed with him. After Paul had assisted his Bomber debut here tonight, would, I'm sure, love to add a goal to that. Ashton Paul in the corner, kicked away, goes back to the Bomber net, picked up by Franz, or back in the LaRange net, rather. And Franz will flip it back to the Bomber blue line. is Chichu Laughlin. That pass got broken up. They remain it through to Justin Lees. Here's a chance here for the Weiss Wolves, but that's blown offside. And hard to believe the Bombers have got 8 goals and still not a single point for Justin Lees in the season or this game tonight.
Well, Rob, I was just going to say, I don't know if Justin Lees is taking a regular shift. He has been out there, but I just say...
Yeah, he might not be 100%.
I'm wondering, because it just seems to me he's not out there a lot.
He's out there now, and here's Ashton Paul, who's got the puck as he makes his way across the LaRonde blue line. Ashton Paul, nice job to kick this one ahead. Piccinino knocks his guy to the ice. Boy, Piccinino like a pinball out there. He is bouncing literally everywhere. Noah Hull holds it in, fakes the shot. Noah Hull lets a rip, save is made. Rebound kicked out from the LaRonde net. Layton will shovel this ahead to Taylor. And Taylor will try to chase it down back in flip-flop territory. There's Noah Hull in the corner for Lees. Back of the goal for Hull. Hull plays that one ahead to Ashton Paul. Paul up to streaking right side for Lees. He tried to catch up with it. Foster cut it off. Lees got a piece but couldn't knock it down cleanly. It goes back in the LaRonde net, picked up by Layton. 12 and a half to go in the third period. Taylor taps that one back to Foster at center. Foster inside the Flin Flon zone will carry it in. Rimmed it around the boards. Ashton Paul poked it ahead. Here's a 2-on-1. Iwanis and Egan. Iwanis looking for a second and he ripped it wide. Oh, a hard shot there, but you got to hit the net. I think he had the goalie beat if that one would have hit the net. Here's Bourgeois. His chance. Glove save made by Sonnef. And he'll hang on. Boy, that was a bullet, wasn't it, by Iwanis?
Sure was. Yeah, he just missed the net. And another great play by Fabrice Bourgeois. He moved into the center of the ice, took a good shot, but that shot of Iwanis was a rocket.
12:08 remaining here in the third period. 43-33 the shots in favor of Flin Flon. An 8-5 Bomber lead is Egan, Iwanis, and Mueller go back to work. Bourgeois and Yakubchuk on the back end. Bourgeois along the boards to Mueller. Back to Bourgeois. Shoots it. Save made. Loose puck. Trying to get the front. That was Egan. He was hauled down. He was looking for a call, and he might have had a case there.
He did have a case for sure.
Wolves back the other way. Back out front. Silzer dishes it off. A backhander wide open. Net again, and they just can't convert. One pass too many. Silzer goes back to center. Off the glass. Took a funny hop. Came right back in front of the flip-flop net. Grabbed here by Yakubchuk. Baldwin will force him. Pass too far. I think Mueller got a stick on it. And the puck will roll back down. Mueller did touch it, but I don't think the referee saw it. Anyway, a face-off back at the Flin Flon zone with 11 and a half to go. Lots of hockey left here at the Whitney Forum tonight.
Absolutely. 8-5, you think it'd be over, but it ain't.
21-16, the Argos lead the Blue Bombers. Rematch of the Grey Cup, but that's quite the score when you consider who Toronto does not have in uniform tonight. Just seeing what's happening across the SJHL. Weber, a nice start to them on the year. Have Estevan down 4-2 late in the second period. Nipwin, a 6-1 lead on Kindersley, getting ready for the third. Battleford's come back to take a 5-3 lead on Yorkton late in the second period. And Melfort leads Notre Dame 3-0 late in the second. The Hounds are here for a pair of games next Friday, Saturday.
The officials look like they made a mistake on that icing. They're going to put this at center ice.
Well, here comes the faceoff between Semp and Forsberg. LaRonde able to get their number one line out there. A little bit of mismatch here, but there's a breakaway in front. Handel shoots. Save is made by Marquardt. I don't know how Handel got that open, how the puck got to him, but he was alone in front of the net. And as this game looms on, that could be a really, really big save here for Kenny Marquardt. Handel, a pretty dangerous LaRonde forward, gets a great opportunity. Puck lifted on target. Marquardt the save. And boy, that could have been really, really interesting had he scored there.
That was a big save. You know, there's a few goals Kenny would like back, but let's not forget that first period.
No.
Where he stopped three breakaways.
And a couple 2-on-1.
Yeah, with fantastic saves. That middle frame was a little rough on him, but...
Well, just one of those games, right?
Yep, absolutely. And not a lot of help from the D.
No, I mean, when you're in a game like this, everybody wants to score. Everybody's jumping up for the play. You're missing assignments.
Yeah.
Been a little bit more
refined.
Yeah, or just strategic here in the third period. Teams sticking their assignments a little bit more as the Wolves have actually had a pretty good third period tonight as they get the puck deep inside the Flin Flon zone. Shots in the third period right now. LaRonja leading Flin Flon 8-4. And they've got the one goal. Cohen Semph, back of his net, almost ran into his own guy. Semph regroups, feeds it ahead to Joey Lees. Joey Lees will take off. There's a pass off a skate, Bridger. Can't pick it up at center. Here comes Forsberg the other direction, ran into his own guy. Loose puck intercepted here by the very explosive Jacob Vogler. His big hat trick tonight, a big factor in the game as they lead it by three. He's also got an assist. Noah Hull, a terrific game, intercepts that, but he can't clear. Franz will keep it in. Hull after it again in the corner. Picked up and flipped back down the ice. I don't know if it'll have enough for icing. I guess it will. Foster goes back to touch, and Flin Flon not playing with the same urgency as they were in the first couple of periods, and I'm sure that's been the message of the Bomber dressing room. Great to score, guys, but got to look after our own end here, and I think Flin Flon, a little bit more conservative maybe in the third period.
I don't think it's that they're, I agree with you, Rob, I don't think it's that they're sitting on the lead. They just want to make sure they protect their
own. Don't collapse.
Yeah.
10:01 to go, third period. It remains an 8-5 Flin Flon lead. LaRonche, the big goal, 5 seconds into the period. Right back in it again. Flin Flon wins the faceoff. They'll chip this one in. Leighton better hurry. He's got the dangerous Vogler on him. Lost it. Back of the goal. They come right back up front. Puck is laying there. And Steglin couldn't knock it in. He's got quite the battle going on at the side of the LaRonche net. We got penalties all the way around here.
I think he's just calling the...
Steglin and Graham are going at it to the side of the LaRonche net here. And that's who's going to get the penalty is Graham, or maybe both guys. I think both players are going to go here. They were involved in that big scuffle at the side of the LaRonche net.
I think it's just the ice wolf, Rob.
Well, you might be right.
He was the aggressor there.
We tied him up, too.
Yeah.
Well, Flin Flon does have a power play goal tonight. They're 1-for-4. We'll see what they can do on their fifth opportunity.
They got to get going on this power play, Rob.
Well, they got to go power play. Got a goal last time.
Yeah.
A lot of offense out there again. Justin Lees, Ashton Paul, Alexi Silvestri, Noah Hull, who's got the puck, and Jacob Vogler. Like I said, that's a lot of firepower. Vogler, who's got the power play goal, gets it back to Hull. Here's Justin Lees. Nice pass off on Ashton Paul! Makes a quick chance, and that goes off the left shoulder. Her play continues. I think the guys thought that the puck came out of over the glass, but it stays in play. Alexi Silvestri. Come back out front. Jacob Vogler will knock it down. Back to Noah Hull. Out front to Justin Lees. Side of the goal here for Ashton Paul. Won't shoot it. Back out front to Lees. Here's Hull at the blue line. Hangs on, drops it back. Vogler, Lees shoots. Oh, I think that glanced off the crossbar, but a beautiful setup. Boy, I'll tell you what, follow the bouncing puck. Silvestri trying to work it back out front. Here's Hull, a chance. Blocker save made here by Sonnet. The rebound will come back to center. And that's picked up and shoveled right back to Silvestri. A minute to go on the power play. They get it to Ashton Paul down the wing. Paul tried to get to the center of the ice. He did, and then he took a bit of a whack here by Taylor. Got it back of the goal to Silvestri. They'll work it back out front to Lees. This is Tamchuk, a goal tonight along the boards. Back out front to Lees. Nice pass out front. Ashton Paul can't get her to go. Sawed up a nice glove save on him. And the rebound cleared down the ice. And terrific looking power play here, Mike Slip, but they can't beat Sonov. He's had a couple nice stops here.
Ashton Paul, a big addition to this power play.
A lot of lone time in front of the net. Here comes Liam Bridger flying down the ice. Bridger goes to coast, tries to finish, and Sonov takes it off the glove. Oh, that would have been a picture of beauty. Liam Bridger with firecrackers in his skates just took off. Coast to coast, beat everybody except for Sonov, the goalie. What a save. Sonoff again, or Bridger again, rather. Lost the handle, comes back to Egan to drive it. Save is made, puck is bouncing in the crease, it's loose. Oh, they can't shuttle it in. Piccinito ends up firing the goalie's stick out of the way as he tried to jam that one in. Piccinito seeing daylight, but the puck stays out. Tanchuk over to Matt Egan. Knocked to the ice, and here comes Forsberg for Taylor. Forsberg tried to get a lone out front. Egan back to knock that one away. Puck is bouncing. Marcourt will cover it up. And the Bombers did everything but score on that power play. Ashton Paul, a great chance. Silvestri, a great chance. Justin Lee's a great chance. And
Liam Bridger.
How about that rush by Liam Bridger?
Liam Bridger's had a nice game.
It might be one of the better games I've seen him play.
Yeah, he looks like we got one. The Bombers look.
Yeah, Cohen Semp going to take a penalty.
Cohen's been in the penalty box a few times tonight.
So Flint Flon 1-for-5 on the power play, but boy, really should have got awarded with a goal there. That's as good a power play as they've had all year.
Yeah.
Everybody on the ice was touched with the puck. They had great movement, but again, you mentioned the guys that got on the ice. You got Walker, you got Sylvester, you got Lees, you got Paul. That's so much tremendous offensive talent.
And you know, I really, really think that Ashton Paul is the key that was missing. He, a player like Ashton Paul, he's so good with a puck. He's smart hockey player.
And like I said, he's got the size. And
yeah.
He's really tough to play off the
yeah.
puck. You don't see him get bumped off the puck hardly ever.
I'll tell you who else has had a great game is Anthony Piccinino. You can't get him off the puck, but it's not because they're trying to hit him off the puck. They can't catch him.
Yeah, he's been a good spark plug for Flint Flon tonight. It's been a very exciting game. 51-35 right now, the shots in favor of Flint Flon, but a big power play here for the Wolves. If they could get to pay dirt here, could make it a two-goal game once again, and still plenty of time on the clock with roughly 7 minutes remaining in the third period.
Yeah, absolutely, Rob. This is big.
So Forsberg will line up here against Silvestri. 7:21 remaining in the third period, an 8-5 Flint Flon lead. And a big opportunity here for the Wolves. 1-for-5 on the power play. Off the draw. Jacob Wachler around the boards. Cassett will wait for it at the right point. He'll knock it down. Shoveled that one in for Forsberg. Here's Forsberg out front. Seltzer from the blue line. Ripped that one over top of the net. A hard drive there. Forsberg along the boards to Bukart. 4 goals for him in this game. Knocked free by Silvestri. Silvestri's got Wachler. Wachler a hat trick tonight. Would love to add a shorthanded goal, I'm sure. Looking for the pass back of the ice wolf net, but Cassett will get it back. And Cassette's got it. Swings the pass to Handel at center. Handel will get a hold of it. He'll flip it inside Flint Flon territory. Wachler leans into that one. Silvestri will get it, and he'll clear it out. A minute 15 to go in the ice wolf power play. 6.5 remaining in the third period. Don't forget the rematch. Back in LaRange tomorrow, 8:30 Manitoba time. Here's Forsberg. Inside the Bomber zone. Back to the point to Cassette. Silzer's shot. Blocked by Egan. Didn't know where it was. Nice job by Egan to come out front and knock that one away. Puck will go back to the Bomber net. Forsberg. Tapped it along the boards. Mueller in there. Trying to break this one up. Trying to use his big frame to his advantage along the boards. Ties up a Cassette. Silzer will hold it in. Back out front. There's a chance for Handel. A shot didn't miss by much. Cassette's got the loose puck. Works his way back out front. To the blue line, the Silzer. Back to Cassette. A hard drive. That one went wide. Flint Flon running around a little bit here in their own zone. What's going on now? Kenny Marcourt tied up. Another penalty coming up here.
It's going against the Flint Flon Bombers.
Marcourt tied up here with Forsberg. Is he going to get the penalty? The Bomber goalie, he had him down and was whacking away on him. I think Kenny Marcourt might, unless somebody hit the player into Marcourt. But a 5-on-3 for the Wolves here with 25 seconds to go in the first penalty. Boy, what a chance for them. Opportunity knocking here for LaRange with 5:46 to play in the third period. And I'm not sure if the Bomber goalie is getting the penalty or somebody had hit him into the goalie.
I think he is. Brock Mueller is going to take the penalty.
Well, it's had to be somebody that was on the ice, but...
Yeah. This is a little scary for the Bombers, 5-on-3.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's a bit of an undisciplined penalty on his part.
Yes, it is.
You can't whack a guy when he's laying on the ice like that with the referee standing right there. Big face-off here. The Bombers will try to hold it off. It is Marcourt, the goalie. He'll get the roughing call, and it'll be a 5-on-3. Great chance here for the Wolves. Here's Cassette in the corner, looking for the return pass. Yakubchuk trying to tie it up. 6 seconds remaining in the first penalty. Yakubchuk, nice job, got it to the blue line. Knocked down by Silzer. Back out front to Forsberg. Forsberg will hang on, throws it back out front. Semp is out, so the first penalty is over. LaRange 1-for-6 in the game. But they have control of it. They'll throw it back to blue line. Silzer back out front to Forsberg. Chipped in for Cassette. And I've noticed that Kaminsky has not changed up the power play unit. They've been going the whole distance here. on this entire 5-on-3 chance. They've got the puck inside the Flin Flon zone. Somebody's got the puck underneath them. I think it's Semp. I can't see the number here from my vantage point. Forsberg came out in the corner with it. Back out front to Silzer. Hangs on, trying to throw it back out front. Sylvester got a piece of it. Did get to handle eventually. He'll throw it back in the goal. And the Wolves will work it back to Silzer at the blue line. That's Bukart. Silzer fanned on it, knocked down, picked up here, and fired down the ice by Silvestri. 46 seconds remaining in the second penalty. Silzer back to get it. Silzer has got it. Dropped it back to Leighton at center. Fires that one inside the Flin Flon zone. Jumping in the play this time is Dragon. He's had a couple of assists in this game tonight. Big boy. Tried to hold it up there. Lee's out there as well. Can't tap it free. Leighton back up front. And fanning on that one was Franz. Puck at the side of the bomber net. Picked up here by Noah Hull. Down the ice it goes. Here comes Piccinino. Short-handed. Piccinino in tight. Open net. They score. And guess what? I believe that's Ashton Paul that'll shovel it in. Oh, sorry. No, Justin Lees from... It's Justin Lees. He'll get his first ever SKHL goal. These orange jerseys are throwing me off. Anyway, a great job by Lees to get to the front of the net. Big game for him, and we mentioned no points yet. There's a big goal there, and that's a shorthanded goal by Justin Lees.
Anthony Piccinino was the linchpin there. He played a great game.
Well, he was the key on that. Boy, he got down the ice quickly, didn't he?
Yeah, he has been flying out there tonight.
So Justin Lees, the Bomber captain, gets his first of the year. Piccinino, I'm assuming, is going to get an assist. And it's a shorthanded goal by Flin Flon, who will take the 9-5 lead here with just under 4 minutes remaining in the third period. Penalty is over. Here's a chance in front for Lees again. He gets tripped up. He's looking for a call. Boy, Lees that close to getting in alone the second time. And that's a big, big goal for Flin Flon. They'll send it in deep. And picked up here by the Iceville goaltender, Sonop. And a 9-5 Flin Flon lead with 3:25 to go. And boy, the top line of Bomber players have really broken out offensively in this game. We're going to have a scrap here. He's unloading here on Token. Token got the jersey up, but Lees drops the mitts here. He and Token go at her. Lees comes over to the LaRange bench here, has a few things to say. Kevin Kaminsky's not happy about that. And we could have a wild finish here tonight. Cow, it's just going deafening in here tonight. When Lees went at it with Tokic, he came over and had a few comments for the LaRange bench, and Kevin Kaminsky, the Iceville head coach, did not like that. An old school guy.
He is an old school guy.
So 3:25 to go. Lees, a memorable third period, gets his first of the year, gets in a scrap moments later, and we'll see what happens in the final 3:25. Like I said, these two teams going to go back at her in LaRange tomorrow night.
Yeah, you knew something was going to erupt, I think, Rob, with the way this game has gone. And
so Kevin Kaminsky has called the referee over. He does not like what Justin Lees did. And I'm not sure if he gestured or what he did, but Kevin Kaminsky is upset about something. And he called the referee over immediately. But, I mean, in the referee's defense on this one, I don't think he saw it. They're discussing it, though. I guess he's trying to find out if somebody else did.
Well, I mean, there's talking on to each other's bench all game. I you know.
Yeah, but what did he say?
That's what we don't know.
I mean, it caught Kevin Kaminsky's attention, so it had to be something. Anyway, we got 3:25 remaining here.
Still talking about it.
So 3:25 remaining. Shots are 53-36 Flin Flon. Lees has scored here, so I'm not sure what's going on now. Now they come over to the Bomber bench here.
They're going to send somebody to the box. No. Yeah.
He's
going to get it unsportsmanlike.
So he said something that was obviously inappropriate, I'm thinking. so he's wondering why the faceoff's in there.
Oh, fair enough, fair enough.
It should come outside the zone, and it will.
I was listening to the Spit and Chicklets podcast, and they were talking about the killer on there and his old school ways. Oh, it looks like maybe offsetting.
Yeah, penalty's been hit. Another LaRange player is headed to the box. That's Gary. So it's 4-4. There's alarms and sirens going off everywhere here tonight. Really tough to think up in the booth. But here come the calls. So just a fighting major that he announced for Leeds anyway. Here comes Liam Bridger across the LaRange line. Sent will pick it up. Back out front. Bridger gets a shot away, but he sends that one over top of the Ice Wolf net. Puck set back towards the Bomber blue line. Owen Semp on side. Bridger cutting in behind the knee. Gets a quick chance. And boy, Bridger really wants that goal tonight, doesn't he?
He sure does. Like you said, Rob.
He's worked very hard.
Maybe one of the best games Liam Bridger has played.
A lot of hustle tonight. And he took that big pancake hit earlier, but got right back up.
Yeah, he went.
I think he showed his teammates what he's made of after that hit.
Yeah.
Not easy to get up from that. Cassette's a big guy. Faceoff back inside the light LaRange zone. 2:39 remaining in the third period. Yakub took back for the Bombers. Almost lost it. Silzer came over and took it away from him. Got a shot away. Tied him up again. Yakub Chuck trying to rebound along the boards. Knocked out here by Bukart. 4 goals for him. Back to Silzer. A shot for top of the Bomber net. Glancing off the glove that time. And Kenny Moorcourt. The loose puck picked up by the Wolves. Back of the Bomber net. This is Bukart again with it. Bukart to the blue line, spins, fires, blocked. Mueller will get it back to center. Here's a chance for Awanis by himself. He gets a quick chance, and Sonnep will get enough of that to knock it off target. Mueller pinned up along the wall, this time by Franz. And Forsberg grabs the loose puck, less than 2 minutes to go. Forsberg has to regroup in his own zone. Feeds it late in the pass to center to Franz. Franz will carry the puck inside the Flin Flon zone. Pumped off the play. Here comes Matt Egan. Matt Egan back the other direction. He gets a quick chance, and there's a nice glove save made by Sonnep. And Egan himself having a nice night tonight as well.
I was just going to say he's made some really nice defensive moves, and he's hit hard like Matt Egan does.
He's got a lot of jump in his step.
And he's flying, yeah.
9-5, Flin Flon leads at 1:38 to go. The Bombers have now hit 56 shots in the game. Joey Lees lines up in the faceoff against Cassette. Nice crowd here tonight. 8:49 here for a Friday night with a lot of stuff happening in town with Culture Days. Of course, we had the soccer zones here today and a whack of other activities happening. Semple gets it over to Lees, who gets the quick chance. And pad save made by Sonnep. 1:19 to go. Flin Flon now up to 57 shots. We'll see if they can hit 60 in the final minute 19. Lees getting ready for the draw. That's Joey Lees. Coming over and have a little word here with Matt Egan, what he wants to do on the faceoff. As he'll take the draw here against Betzel. Wolves win the faceoff. This is Layton. To Babic at center. Lees intercepts that. Back to Egan. Egan by himself outside the LaRange blue line. Tapped it ahead to Lees, but right on the stick that time of Layton. The Wolves get it right back that fast. This is Foster. Sends it inside the Flin Flon zone, and icing call against LaRange. We'll get a face. Ours are almost holding up too many hands, like too many men on the ice there, I thought, maybe, but. So 56.8 seconds to go. And we'll get a face off back to center, so that was a blown call.
Another two of those tonight.
Semp digging in here against Bezel. Puck rolls back in the LaRange line, grabbed by Foster. Feeds this one back to Babic. Babic had to be careful of Bridger on top of him. And Bridger knocked it away. Cohen Semp trying to make something happen. To the blue line, knocked down by Bourgeois. Bourgeois hanging on to it. Bourgeois, good work along the boards, keeps it in. He's had a good game tonight too. Semp tried to get on top of that one. Gets tied up with his guy, and the loose puck is picked up by Bezel. Back to Babak at center, 18 seconds remaining. Babak across the line. Hangs on to it. Bumped off the plate that time. A nice body check. Courtesy here of Bourgeois. They might get out of here.
I don't think Babak wants to take Mr. Fabrice on.
Well, one guy, Graham, came in there. He looked like he was obliged to. Going to be an interesting matchup back in LaRange
tomorrow.
It sure
will be, Rob. It sure will be.
So Babak and Bourgeois were jousting at each other. The big guy, Graham, came flying in there, said he'd like to get involved. And we'll see if that carries over to tomorrow night. Actually, what that gesture that Graham just did, you can get a penalty for that. You can't do much of the game of hockey anymore.
He got the heave, but there's only 6.1 seconds left.
The Flint Flon Bombers are going to pick up their second win of the year. Remain undefeated, or unbeaten now in three games with the overtime loss and the two victories against the Hawks and the Wolves. And no doubt will be a little bit tougher for them at the Mel Hedlund tomorrow night.
Yeah.
So 6.1 seconds to go, 57-36 the shots in favor of Flint Flon. And they'll drop the puck here and get ready for the rematch back in LaRange tomorrow night. Baldwin lining up for the faceoff against Semp just outside the blue line. Off the draw, picked up by France. He'll flip it in. And that's good enough for the game here tonight. So the two teams trade goals in the third period. And it winds up a 9-5 Flint Flon victory. And I don't know if I would have, anybody would have believed me that I'd say 14 goals would have been scored in this hockey game.
No. It wasn't a defensive masterpiece.
Well, the third period it tightened up.
It did, but I think the Bombers had to.
Yes, absolutely.
Really interesting game.
The Bombers will take it. As well with the 9 goals here tonight. Maybe some confidence here for a lot of guys that were kind of stifled the first couple of games.
Yeah.
Again, a breakout game for Silvestri, a breakout game for Bachler. Justin Lee fights through to get his first goal of the year. A good night for Bourgeois. I mean, Tkachuk gets a goal tonight. I mean, a good night for a lot of guys, if nothing else, on the confidence standpoint. You can certainly tell they're jacked up as they make their way off the ice.
Yeah.
The guys that weren't dressed tonight.
Absolutely.
Ross and Carroll in particular looking pretty pumped up and excited down there.
He's an excitable guy. I don't know if we're doing the 3-star draw, but I'm just writing down what I think.
Well, I'll tell you what, you're going to have lots of time. I'll run down all the goals here
quickly.
Going to take a while. We'll go back to the opening period of the 5:33. Mark Alexi Silvestri gets his first of the year. Walker the assist on that one, and that was just a really nice goal by Silvestri. It seems like an eternity ago now.
Yeah.
They got the puck behind the net, got it, and was able to shovel it in the 5-hole for his first of the year. Then Silvestri returned the favor. He set up Bachler here for his first of the year at 14:03. Quickly 2-0 before Bourgeois would get his first from Paul. And that would make it a 3-0 game for Flint Flon at 15:05. Big late goal for the Ice Wolves. They score with less than a full second on the board. Bucourt, boy, he had himself a nice game tonight. His first from Taylor at 19:59. 3-1 Flint Flon after one. Ice Wolves a couple of quick goals. As Franz would get his first unassisted at 5:19. Then Bucourt again. His second from Graham at 6:34 had it tied up. And the Bombers went to work as again as they'd score 4 straight. Vockler. Second tonight, second of the season. Silvestri and Houle, the assist at 6:49. Iwanis comes back. His first from Mueller and Egan at 8:22. Then Steglin continues his hot play, his fourth goal to lead the team in 3 games. Silvestri, he gets the assist on that one at 8:51. And then Vockler would score yet again. Third of the night to convert the hat trick, the power play goal from Noah Houle that came at 11:13. Ice Wolves would fight into the lead once again to make it 8-4. Bucourt would convert the hat trick. Taylor and Dragon the assist at the 12-minute mark. Things would settle down. Flint Flon would get one late goal as Cole Tkachuk would get his first from Semp and Bridger at 16:57. So Flin Flon taking an 8-4 lead into the third. The Ice Wolves have scored just 5 seconds in. Beauchamp, fourth goal of the night. I guess he could take homage in that. Probably not happiest team lost the game, but it's not very often you score 4 goals in one game anymore.
Yeah.
So he would get that right off the faceoff. He walked in, he hammered it home. They do give Forsberg an assist on that. Then Justin Lees would score a late goal at 16:04, his first of the year. Piccinino the assist. And that would wind down the scoring shots in the third period. Once again, favoring Flin Flon 17-9. The Bombers wind up with 57 tonight. The Wolves wind up with 36. LaRange 1-for-7 on the power play. Flin Flon winds up 1-for-5 and do pick up their second win of the year. Before we sign off and get things ready for tomorrow night, you got the big three-star selection.
Well, I do. It's a tough one. But it's not tough for the first two, as you can imagine. But third star we're going to give to Alexi Silvestri. I thought he had his best game of the year. Second star, how can we not say if they would have won the game, he would have been the first star. Mason Bukart.
Yeah, 4 goals.
4 goals. And number one star tonight, Jacob Bachler, with a hat trick. And, it's great to see those guys. We knew they weren't going to stay off the score sheet for long, and they didn't. Warrior of the game, I'm going to give to Liam Bridger after that hit, and he came back and just played an outstanding game. I don't think he got any goals or points, but he just
played. He got an assist.
He did.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many guys that you can give honorable mentions, but I'm going to just mention three more. Anthony Piccinino, I thought, had a fantastic game as a Warrior. Fabrice Bourgeois, I thought, played a good first game of his SJHL career.
He sure did.
And Ashton Paul came out with a flurry. So, I don't want to miss anybody, but those who came to mind.
Well, no question about it. Jacob Bachler, the hat trick, a 4-point night, star number one. Bukart had 4 of the 5 LaRange goals, deserving of star number two. And Alexi Silvestri, a 4-point night, including a goal and 3 helpers, star number three. And like you mentioned, Liam Bridger, great tonight. Bourgeois was good. Piccinino played well. And again, they were flying. It was River Pond hockey here for the first couple of periods. The two teams did tighten up in the third period. And boy, where does this kind of leave you? What's your mindset heading into LaRange tomorrow now?
Tighten up defensively.
No, but I mean the game tonight, how does that lead into tomorrow?
Well, you know that we got a little testy at the end, so I imagine that'll carry over.
I'll see you tomorrow. I don't do it.
It'll be interesting. It'll be interesting to see what happens tomorrow, Rob. I don't know how it leaves you. I don't know what you take from this game, except that we look great offensively, both sides. We didn't look good defensively. So.
Well, and the thing is, too, it just shows you. I mean, Flin Flon jumped out quickly 3-0 tonight,
yeah.
And bang, the Wolves came back and tied it and got that goal again early in the third, got right back. And they got some guys that can play, too. I can tell you right now, if you want me to make a prediction, you're not going to see 14 goals scored tomorrow.
No. And, Rob, you and I sat here, and we never really felt comfortable.
Well, not the way the game was going.
No,
it's just
no,
too dangerous
right.
When you leave your end unattended like that.
That's right.
Anyway, full marks to Flin Flon. They tightened up when they had to. And, again, like I said, it's a big night for a number of guys that were able to, kind of get off the side, so to speak.
Yeah.
Some guys that needed some confidence, they got that. And that's a big goal for Justin Lees in the third period tonight, too, who probably, like you mentioned earlier, probably still not 100% healthy.
No, but Boyle nearly said it.
Jeez, you've been pretty good tonight.
I know.
It's only the radio games you like to let those fly.
Anyways, he a heck of a fight. So he didn't look
anywhere he likes to rock the mitts again from time to time.
He's a strong young man.
Anyway, full marks to Flin Flon. They did what they had to do. They pick up the 9-5 victory. We will be in LaRange tomorrow night. Make sure you listen to 102.9 CFE or flinflononline.com. Of course, it's a big day tomorrow, of course, with Truth and Reconciliation Day. And I know the Ice Wolves have got orange sweaters that they're going to unveil tomorrow night. And I'm thinking going to be a very big crowd in LaRange for that game tomorrow night.
Yeah, absolutely. And, it's great to recognize and understand our Indigenous people.
And don't forget, no matter where you may make your way tomorrow to wear an orange shirt.
Absolutely. Got mine ready. I wore one today for a while.
You must look like a big pumpkin with that.
I did.
Hey, you can celebrate Halloween and Truth to Reconciliation Day at the same time there, Mike.
That's right.
But no more importantly, do wear those orange shirts tomorrow in support of this big, big day. And, of course, make sure you listen. Oh, hopefully you can listen into the game tomorrow from LaRange as well as we'll hit the air. Once again, with the Great North GM Coaches Show at 8:10. Drop of the puck at 8:30. So the final score, the Bombers win this one 9-5. Good night for the Whitney Forum on Flow TV.